of Riverfront Broadcasting Sports. It's time for Owyhee Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports. Capital City, Ford, Lincoln, and Toyota. Owyhee Capitals Hockey is brought to you by Hermans and Endodontics, AGE, Weatherall, Ramcota, and Wagner Auto.
There's a shot, they score! Eric Schweitzer, his second of the game, and the Caps have their first lead, 4-3, with 9:42 to go in the third period.
And by Xander Auto Parts, Envirotech, Leisure Palace, the Clubhouse Hotel and Suites, the South Dakota Office of the Attorney General, Division of Consumer Protection, and Pizza Ranch.
Keller Herman off the faceoff win. That shot, rebound, they score! Aiden Beam! His first of the season! First of his career! And the Capitals lead it 3-2.
Owyhee Capitals Hockey is also brought to you by Dano's Marine, American Family Insurance Brittany Schaffelbein Agency, Ferding Electric, First United Methodist Church, and Beck Motors.
From the net, it comes in front, they score! With 1.9 to go, Ashton Greaves ties the game! With the goalie pulled twice, they score twice, and we are tied!
And now for the voice of the Owyhee Capitals, award-winning KCCR Sports Director, John Winkler.
And as we welcome you here for tonight's contest between the Owyhee Capitals and the Huron All-Stars, it should be a good one between these two teams as the Caps are looking for an opportunity to get their fifth straight win and also their seventh straight game with the points as the Caps come in at 6-3-1 and take on the Huron All-Stars here coming in at 2-10 on the season. And this Owyhee Capitals team, they've been playing well, although they've been off for over a week. They have not played since they beat Sioux Center in two shutouts as the two goalies that are standing in near the nets right now with Jackson Youngworth between the pipes. He will be the starting goalie for tonight's game between the Caps and the All-Stars. But this is a big matchup to get 2 points and then move on from here and to play Saturday and Sunday against the Brookings Rangers and the Rushmore Thunder, as those will be the two of the biggest games of the season to this point for the Owyhee Capitals. They were scheduled to play Brookings last Saturday. Obviously, that game got postponed because of the extreme cold, and now the those two teams will meet tomorrow as they will take on they'll be taking on the Brookings Rangers tomorrow night as they are getting set for what will be a big contest over the next 2 days. The Owyhee Capitals and the Huron All-Stars coming up from the Expo Center. We'll talk about the starting lineups, the starting goalies for both these teams, and the Capitals, who have played well over the last couple of days, or last couple of games. They're looking for an opportunity to keep that rolling. And if there's some rust to be shown tonight, you don't want to say that you're going to overlook the Huron All-Stars, but if you're going to show rust over these three games, you want to show rust tonight against the Huron All-Stars. But this is a very important win to pick up. We'll talk with Coach Steve Steele about that here in just a little bit, that you can't overlook anybody. You can't have a bad game. You got to beat the teams that you're supposed to beat, and that is one of the cases. That the Huron All-Stars are a team that you have to beat, and they have to play well tonight. You have to get a win. You can't let the All-Stars get a win because of how the rest of this season goes. Your C points, or not your C points, but the amount of points you have and your seeding at the end of the season could alter tremendously if you don't pick up a win against the Huron All-Stars. The Caps won 8-5 back on earlier this season on a Saturday night in Huron. So now they're looking for the season sweep of the Huron All-Stars coming up here this evening. A little bit behind schedule. We were scheduled to start at 8:30 for a puck drop, but it will be just a little bit later than that. Well, we're looking maybe for puck drop to be around closer to 9 o'clock here at the Expo Center between the Caps and the All-Stars. We will step aside. When we come back, we will talk with Steve Steele, the head coach of the Owyhee Capitals. You're listening to Owyhee Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock. You're watching it on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
fit your budget. Wagner Auto is your local full-service family-owned dealership for over 115 years. WagnerAuto.com. That's WagnerAuto.com. One place to go.
Dr. Brian Hermanson serves Central South Dakota with specialty root canal treatment. Hermanson Endodontics aims to provide treatment that is not only comfortable, but has a quality-first emphasis. We believe that by preserving as much healthy tooth as possible, we can help you retain your natural teeth longer. This is accomplished with state-of-the-art three-dimensional imaging and the dental operating microscope to guide diagnosis and treatment. Ask your dentist if a root canal specialist is right for you. Hermanson Endodontics, 1709 North Lincoln Avenue in Pierce.
When you're in the need for high-quality replacement auto parts, look no further than Zander Auto Parts and Machine Shop in Pierre. Zander's has been servicing the Pierre area for over 40 years. Their professional parts techs can get you the parts you need and get you back on the road. Stop by Zander Auto Parts and Machine Shop at 500 Pierre or call 224-9221. Zander's, your source for domestic and foreign auto parts and accessories.
Weatherall Roofing and Insulation is a family-owned business that has served Central South Dakota for over 25 years. Weatherall Roofing and Insulation specializes in metal roof restorations and flat roof repair. They also offer the highest quality insulation using closed-cell polyurethane foam and blow-in fiberglass. For all your roofing or insulation needs, make Weatherall your first choice. And remember, just foam it.
Dano's Marine supports Oahe Capitals Hockey. Stop in and see the new owners, originally from Pierre, Brandon and Amanda Larson. Dano's Marine technicians are here to help with all your motor needs. They can rig accessories and electronics in all brands of boats or get you into a new boat or pontoon. Dano's Marine, 916 Deadwood Street in Fort Pierre. Don't forget to winterize your boats. Call Dano's Marine at 605-224-6612.
Conference Center in Pierre is a proud supporter of Hawaii Capitals Hockey. Graham Cota is more than just a place to stay. It's a full-service hotel where you'll arrive as a guest and leave as a friend. Enjoy our comfortable accommodations while you're in Pierre. A full bar and restaurant, too. Best of luck to the Hawaii Capitals Hockey teams. The support comes from your friends at the Graham Cota Hotel and Conference Center. Graham Cota Hotel and Conference Center, 920 West 2 Avenue in Pierre. Give us a call at 605-224-6877.
AGE Corporation has been building South Dakota for nearly 60 years. For all your site work, construction, and crane needs, AGE is there for you. If you need a boat dock and dock lighting, AGE has what you need. Visit their website, agecorp.com, or give them a call at 223-2732. AGE Corporation, providing high-quality services without sacrificing safety. Visit agecorp.com or call 223-2732.
When you're looking for quality trash pickup services, look no further than Envirotech. 6 days a week, their trucks are on the road picking up trash, even holidays. They're also the place to contact for recycling services. Their friendly, professional staff is ready to assist with weekly pickups or even special pickups. Check out the website at envirotechwaste.com. Envirotech is locally operated. Call 224-4804. Envirotech Waste Services in Pierre. Proud to support high school athletics.
Hi, this is Keller Herman, and you're listening to Oahe Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back to the pregame show here at Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports, join me as Coach Steve Steele. Coach, you had a weekend off not playing against Brookings last Saturday. Now a three-game weekend this weekend. It's a complete different look. Then you're off next weekend, too. But obviously, first things first is here on tonight. But going into this three-game weekend, is it nice to have that weekend off to get guys very fresh and ready to go for a three-game stretch?
Yeah, you know, I think you definitely worry about a little bit of rust. But, you know, at the same point in time, you know, it wasn't a planned weekend off. It was just one that happened to be that way after the weather. But, you know, we had a good week of practice, and, you know, definitely a little rest going into this weekend isn't a bad thing.
Now, going into this game to against the Huron All-Stars, this is the rest of the weekend shapes up against Brookings and Rushmore, top two teams in the league, Huron right now, and a team that's just trying to find anything to get going to get themselves in the top eight to make the state tournament. So how do you make sure guys aren't overlooking this game, and do you almost say it's like a tune-up game for the rest of the weekend?
Yeah, you know, in a lot of ways, we've looked at the standings, and you know, we've had a lot of conversations that, you know, teams, it's hard to survive a bad game this year. You know, the league's very, very close, and, you know, I think we'll see that this over the course of the whole weekend. But, you know, we're not immune. We can't play a bad game and expect to beat anybody, so we've got to be on top right from the get-go.
On Jackson Youngworth, we'll get the start net here tonight. How key is it for shots to come on early? Not a whole lot of shots because you don't want to see here on Pepper the goalie early on, but for him to get in the flow of things, again, without having a game last weekend.
Yeah, you know, he'll just have to come out confident. You know, again, I think our goalies are both playing fantastic right now. You know, they're both playing with a lot of confidence. They're practicing well during the week, which is a very important part. So, I mean, it's, you know, whenever the first shots come, we've got to play good defense, and he's just got to stop the ones, and, you know, he'll have good vision and confidence tonight.
And then the offensive side, how key is it to get shots early on, get shots on goal, and get guys in the rhythm of the game early?
Yeah, you know, it's going to be important to get the first one and get out in front. You know, they've got one really good shooter. We've got to lock him down. And then, you know, yeah, I think their goalie had a great game against us last time. You know, we've got a couple adjustments that we're going to try and do to hopefully get on them a little bit earlier today.
And again, a three-game weekend where you got, thankfully it's all at home, but how important is it to jump out to that start but not let off the gas at any point in this game, but to have yourself a less stressful of a win and less stressful of a game going into what will be tomorrow and Sunday in very good games?
Yeah, it's going to be crucial to do that. You know, I mean, it's going to be just – that's going to make everything else the weekend a little bit smoother if we can take care of business today. And, you know, really take care of it quick. You know, I think that's going to be the big thing. The quicker we can jump and just go right after it, then hopefully the less we'll have to go.
Well, in Sioux Center 2 weekends ago, your power play was very good. Penalty kill didn't get a whole lot of tests, which is also good. You stayed out of the box. But how important has special teams been over this last week, and how do you want to see that continue to go and to continue to grow this weekend?
Yeah, you know, I think our power play has really come a long way. You know, I think we kind of had a lot of the pieces in the right spot and we're moving right. But we just weren't finishing early in the year. And, you know, I think we've really started to turn that on these last 3-4 games. And, you know, our penalty kill has been great by the virtue of not having to use it a whole bunch. So hopefully we can keep both of those things going in the right direction and taking another step forward tonight.
And then tonight, what's the biggest key for the Capitals to get a win?
Just getting an early start. You know, if we can get out early, come out fast, and you know, get the first goal or two, then I think that'll go a long way.
Well, Coach, I appreciate the time. Good luck tonight.
Thanks, John.
Back with more of the pregame show next here on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
Was the time. See Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram vehicles, plus a good selection of quality pre-owned and certified pre-owned vehicles. They'll take care of you after the sale with a full-service parts and auto body shop with trained technicians, along with a friendly financing team that'll work with you to find the best deal and one that'll fit your budget. Wagner Auto is your local full-service family-owned dealership for over 115 years. WagnerAuto.com. That's WagnerAuto.com.
Verdig Electric has a long history of doing electrical work the right way. Economical service, professional work, and customer satisfaction is why they can say that. Verdig Electric can do residential, farm, and commercial projects. Doesn't matter if they are charged with new construction or a remodel project, they get it conducted. Contact the staff at Verdig Electric at 224-8684. They can light a spark into your next project. Verdig Electric, 224-8684.
Hello. I'm Pastor Jeff Lathrop of Pier First United Methodist Church, and I'd like to invite you to join us in person for worship on Sunday mornings at 8:30 a.m. or 11 a.m. You can also join us on Facebook Live or on KCCR 1240 a.m. or 98.9 FM for our Sunday morning broadcast at 11 a.m. Come worship with us at First United Methodist Church, where you will find open hearts, open minds, and open doors.
What makes our business successful? Our people. Beck Motor Company in Pierre takes great pride in our team, and we are looking to add to an opening for a full-time parts consultant. This individual works closely with our service department and collision center customers, as well as walk-in customers, getting them the parts and accessories they need. Experience a plus, but we'll train the right individual. Many benefits, including health insurance. Contact Steve Meyer at 224-5912.
Weatherall Roofing and Insulation is a family-owned business that has served Central South Dakota for over 25 years. Weatherall Roofing and Insulation specializes in metal roof restorations and flat roof repair. They also offer the highest quality insulation using closed-cell polyurethane foam and blow-in fiberglass. For all your roofing or insulation needs, make Weatherall your first choice. And remember, just foam it.
Imagine your backyard turned into an outdoor oasis. Hi, this is Jason with Leisure Palace. Imagine sliding into a hot spring spa and having the jets pulsate and rejuvenate your body, then take a few steps into your own outdoor pool, swimming and enjoying time with family and friends. At Leisure Palace, we have a great selection of spas, pools, and many other items. The guaranteed lowest prices and your oasis for family fun and relaxation. Leisure Palace of Pier.
The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites has Midwestern charm and unprecedented attention to detail that provides the perfect getaway. Hotel and Suites provides a complimentary deluxe continental breakfast featuring hot waffles, biscuits, and gravy. They also have an indoor children's water playland, whirlpool and fitness center, and a beautiful backyard patio with seasonal fire pits. Everyone deserves a night away. Call 605-494-2582 to make your reservation today. The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites. Experience luxury in the heart of South Dakota.
Every day you share personal information about yourself with others. You may write a check, charge fuel, rent a car, mail your tax returns, schedule a doctor's appointment, or post something on social media. Each transaction may share some sort of personal information, such as bank and credit card account numbers, social security number, name, address, or phone number. There are unscrupulous individuals, identity thieves, targeting these routine transactions, trying to gain your information to commit fraud. If you think somebody has stolen your identity, contact Consumer Protection at 1-800-300-1986.
Hi, this is Jace Anderson, and you're listening to Hawaii Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back here and to the Expo Center as the Hawaii Capitals take on the Huron All-Stars coming up here in just a little bit. The Capitals want to use their depth tonight. This is a big game for them to use their depth. They've got three lines that have scored goals, including the third line having six goals combined between Keller Herman, Keegan Kitts, Riley Pfeiffer, those three. And you look at those other two lines, which are pretty much 1A and 1B, the line of Luke Miller, Jaron Beck, and Devin Dotson, they have scored a combined 28 goals. On the other side, it is Barrett Schweitzer, Aiden Dozark, and Dylan Dotson that have combined for 23 goals between those three. The Capitals will go with Jackson Youngworth in net for the Capitals tonight, as he is 2-1 on the season so far. His save percentage is at .912, goals against average at 1.67, and his shutouts, both of his wins have been shutouts so far for the Capitals. On the other side of the Huron All-Stars, they've got two guys that have combined for 20 of their 27 goals scored so far. Ethan Bush with 14 goals, Grady Bott with 6. They have scored those 20 goals. They've got Micah Metter on the line with them. And then Brecken Glanzer, Elliot Hartman, and Monty Bow, those three on the second line, have all scored goals. So they want to try and get two lines going. And Bush and Bott both scored goals against the Capitals in the 8-5 win for a while. Back a couple months ago in the first part of the season. But it is, we believe Jack Bales will be the starting goalie in net for the Huron All-Stars. He's got a win, but goals against average at 6.72. Both goalies with a goals against average above 6 and the save percentage at .833 for Bales, who has played in 8 games, 8 of the 12 games so far. He does have a win of the two for the Huron All-Stars. So the Capitals and the Huron All-Stars coming up from the Expo Center in Fort Pierre. We will step aside one more time. When we come back, we've got starting lineups and the puck drop to begin this game between the Capitals and the All-Stars. Back after this here on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
Transportation headquarters. GMC, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram vehicles, plus a good selection of quality pre-owned and certified pre-owned vehicles. They'll take care of you after the sale with a full-service parts and auto body shop with trained technicians, along with a friendly financing team that'll work with you to find the best deal and one that'll fit your budget. Wagner Auto is your local full-service family-owned dealership for over 115 years. WagnerAuto.com. That's WagnerAuto.com. One place to go.
Pizza Ranch of Fort Pier is a proud supporter of the Oahe Capitals hockey. Bring your crew to the ranch. We have hot buffet options, including legendary pizza, the country's best chicken, savory sides, nutritious salads, and delicious desserts. Perched right on the river, our Fort Pier Pizza Ranch is only minutes away from the South Dakota State Capitol building and from the Expo Center, home of the Oahe Capitals. The Pizza Ranch in Fort Pier.
With any dream, the wind won't always be at your back. The sun won't always be shining, and some rain is going to fall. American Family Insurance is like a good, solid roof that you can trust to protect your biggest dreams. With plans that could save you up to 23% when you buy. Also, you can continue to dream fearlessly, no matter what comes your way. American Family Insurance.
Visit FM.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Contact the Brittany Shelfelbein Agency, LLC, 224-6627.
Refined design. Remarkable capabilities. The Ford Edge at Capital City Ford delivers everyone and everything in style and comfort. Bold and aggressive on the outside, lavish with lots of tech on the inside. This SUV does a whole lot more than haul groceries. Travel with confidence when purchasing your all-new Ford Edge from Capital City Ford. And for a limited time, qualified buyers can purchase at 0.9% APR for 60 months. Check out their full vehicle lineup at CapitalCityFord.com. Capital City Ford in Pier.
South Dakotans, due to the recent flood, hail, and windstorms, many of you have damage and are in need of making repairs. When it comes to making the decision of who to hire to complete the repairs, you should always check with the Department of Revenue to ensure they're licensed to do business in South Dakota. And you should check with Consumer Protection to see if any complaints have been filed against the company. And finally, never sign anything until you read all the details. Rule of thumb, when someone knocks on your door to sell you a product or service, they need to provide you with a 3-day right to cancel. Go to consumersd.gov and look under transient vendors or call 800-300-1986.
The Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center in Pier is a proud supporter of Hawaii Capitals hockey. Ram Kota is more than just a place to stay. It's a full-service hotel where you'll arrive as a guest and leave as a friend. Enjoy our comfortable accommodations while you're in Pier, a full bar and restaurant too. Best of luck to the Hawaii Capitals hockey teams. The support comes from your friends at the Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center. Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center, 920 West Sioux Avenue in Pier. Give us a call at 605-224-6877.
Dano's Marine supports Oahe Capitals hockey. Stop in and see the new owners, originally from Pier, Brandon and Amanda Larson. Dano's Marine technicians are here to help with all your motor needs. They can rig accessories and electronics in all brands of boats, or get you into a new boat or pontoon. Dano's Marine, 916 Deadwood Street in Fort Pier. Don't forget to winterize your boats. Call Dano's Marine at 605-224-6612.
When you're looking for quality trash pickup services, look no further than Envirotech. 6 days a week, their trucks are on the road picking up trash, even holidays. They're also the place to contact for recycling services. Their friendly, professional staff is ready to assist with weekly pickups or even special pickups. Check out the website at envirotechwaste.com. Envirotech is locally operated. Call 224-4804. Envirotech Waste Services in Pier. Proud to support high school athletics.
Hi, this is Corbin Bistrom, assistant captain of the Oahe Capitals, and you're listening to Oahe Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
And as we welcome you back here, the Oahe Capitals and the Huron All-Stars, both teams are taking the ice now. We'll throw it down here in just a moment for the introduction of the starting lineups as the Caps and the All-Stars battling from the Expo Center. Jason Dotson is usually the PA guy, not here tonight. Had a Sixers game with the Magic Sixers game as he is not here for the PA, but we'll throw it down to the PA anyway for the introduction of the starting lineups.
This matchup is between the Huron All-Stars varsity boys and the Oahe Capitals varsity. Starting lineup for the Huron All-Stars. Number six, Tim Alexander Tim. One center, number seven, Grady Bach. One D, number nine, Micah Larson. One forward, number 19, Jack Pedersen. One forward, number 20, Ethan Bush. And their goalie, number Huron All-Stars are coached by Waylon Walters and Keegan McMahon. Now, for the hometown of Hawaii Capitals, number 6, Jared Beck. Going forward, number 10, Lucas Miller. 1D, number 16, Andrew Coughlin. D, number 60, Aiden Reed. And our goalie, number 22, Jackson Youngberg. Hawaii Capitals are coached by Jonathan Katilnik, Paul Nelson, and Steve Steele. Now, if you could please stand, I will
It's time for some hockey here at the Expo Center. Just about 20 minutes behind schedule as the Capitals and the All-Stars are set for puck drop. And the White Capitals are looking for their fifth win in a row. Also trying to get their seventh straight game with at least a point. As they've won five of their last six games, the only non-win was a tie to Sioux Falls East back in the middle of December. The Capitals will start with Jaron Beck, Luke Miller, and Devin Dodson. On the forward line, Aiden Beam, Andrew Coughlin will be the two defensemen. The Huron All-Stars will go with Alex Timm, Grady Bott, and Ethan Bush up on the forwards. And then it will be Jack Peterson and Michael Larson, the two defensemen. Jack Bales will be the starting goalie for the Huron All-Stars. Jackson Youngworth, the starting goalie for the Wyatt Capitals. We're underway here tonight between the Capitals and the Huron All-Stars. It comes into the Capitals end of the ice. Andrew Coughlin will pick it up as it'll be swung around by Aiden Beam. Now for Coughlin again to grab. His backhander up for Devin Dodson. Now for Jaron Beck as they move it in the offensive zone. Beck, his pocket is picked from number 9 in Michael Larson. And it'll come out of the zone, and Ethan Bush now will pick it up. Two on two in. That shot is high, and it goes off the glass. Does not go on net against Youngworth. The first shot attempt of the game from either side. That pass is deflected. Devin Dodson goes all the way down on net. Bales was a little slow to get to, almost bounced too far off of his goal stick, but was able to cover. And we get a whistle at 16:21 to go here in the first period. Just underway here at the Expo Center. We'll talk about scores from across the state coming up in the first intermission report. I know we're just only 39 seconds in this game, but a big matchup of Brookings and Sioux Falls West playing in Sioux Falls tonight. And we'll talk about that score because, again, the Rangers will also be coming to town tomorrow, and that's a the biggest match of the entire night between the for the boys varsity side. This will be picked up at the Huron blue line. Racing in the zone is Brecken Glanzer. He'll leave it back, and now it's grabbed. There's a shot on Youngworth. He'll make the save. Hit him square right in the chest from Mason Hunter. And the first shot on goal is a save for Youngworth. Jackson Youngworth, 2-1 on the season in his three starts. A 1.67 goals against average, 9.12 save percentage. And after losing that first game in net, he's recorded back-to-back shutouts when he's got the two starts against Brandon Valley and Sioux Center. That Sioux Center weekend was two shutouts, both one from Spencer Anderson and one from Youngworth. This one has popped high off the boards. It is gloved down. That's going to be a hand pass. And it will be a whistle before the shot was taken by Mason Hunter. It was off the hands of Monty Bow. So now the faceoff will come just outside the Capitals end, Capitals end of the ice with 15:43 left in the first period. Aiden Dozark will take the faceoff for the Capitals. It is won by the All-Stars, but controlled by the Capitals as Barrett Schweitzer will pass it back. And Jace Anderson up ahead for Dylan Dodson. That'll be tipped into the zone and will go into the corner. And it'll be played by the All-Stars with a pocket picked. And Dozark tries to get out in front. There's a bouncing puck in front. Bales has it for a moment. Doesn't cover it. Can't cover it. And the puck is still loose to the side of the net it comes. Grabbed now by Schweitzer. His shot, he scores! Barrett Schweitzer makes it 1-0 with 15:16 to go in the first period. Right over the top of the goalie's shoulder and Jack Bales, and Schweitzer's got his 11th of the season. In a minute and 44 seconds in, the Hawaii Capitals will strike first. Can't give him too much space. Can't give Schweitzer too much space. He'll make you pay just like he did right there for the Capitals. And it's a 1-0 lead on the American Family Insurance Brittany Shuffle by the scoreboard. This will be played in by the Capitals. They have to tag back up, and it's grabbed by Jonas Buckland. Dozark will get the lone assist as he will pick up assist number 6 on the season. He's now got 15 points as the All-Stars bring it in the end of the ice, and that shot goes off of a body and into the netting. That comes from Grady Botts of the Huron All-Stars. 14:48 to go here in period number one. Capitals lead it on the Barrett Schweitzer goal. And off and running are the Caps here in their first game of a three-game weekend. Only their second shot on goal. All coming right there in a matter of seconds. Devin Dodson will grab it here for the Capitals. He moves in. The puck just goes out of the zone. Jaron Beck will have to play it back over for Andrew Coughlin at the Capitals blue line. Coughlin, hard pass off the stick of Dodson, right to Beck, but he'll circle back in his blue line again. And now Beck will skate in the neutral zone. And as Beck will swing through two defenders, making a third defender, Beck moving in. That shot and a save by Bales got maybe a bit too close and tight. And a save made by Bales with 14:20 remaining here in period number one. The puck went in the netting, so an offensive zone faceoff for the Capitals to the left of Bales. And Beck will take the faceoff against Grady Botts. It is won by the All-Stars as Michael Larson will play. It's over, but it will be grabbed by the Capitals. Beck leaves it back. There's a shot, or maybe thrown toward the corner from Aiden Beam. And now it's played in the corner. Devin Dodson off of his stick and grabbed now by the All-Stars. Hard pass up, but that is broken up. It was coming from Peterson trying to get it over to Ethan Bush. Now here's a pass for Miller, a shot and a right pad save made by the goalie in Bales. There's a pass across, back to Miller, just off of his stick, and then it somehow comes out free to the right side of the ice, and Jaron Beck couldn't get his stick on it, and it's now grabbed by the Capitals. Beam will pass it for his defensive partner in Andrew Coughlin, and that pass up ahead to Beck, where it's tipped off of his stick and into the zone. Behind the net, Schweitzer nearly took the puck away. It has come to the corner, where it's Dozark, but left for the All-Stars. As Tim will move it up. And in the neutral zone, Dozark with the back check to knock the puck away for Schweitzer to grab. And here comes Schweitzer moving back in. Dylan Dodson will keep it in the zone as he was able to follow up from Schweitzer. Centering pass for Dozark. He goes out to the front, to the top, and a shot from Bistrom went wide. A good puck movement here by the Capitals early on in this game against the Huron All-Stars. This will be ice by Huron with 12:50 to go in the first period. And again, the Capitals lead on the Barrett Schweitzer goal. 1:44 in the contest. 1-0 on the American Family Insurance. Brittany Schoffelbein scoreboard. Faceoff will be to the right this time of Jack Bales. Aiden Dozark will take it. And he'll take it against Grady Botts. It'll be won by the All-Stars. Dozark nearly won that draw, but it's grabbed by Ethan Bush, and then he is pinned to the boards. And a good check there by Corbin Bistrup. Pass over for Dozark, and as he'll move in, he'll sidestep a man, and then the puck will go back behind the red line, behind the goal line extended out, and it's a battle for it behind the nets. It's picked up by the Capitals, and Schweitzer plays it around. And it'll come here to the near side where it's grabbed by the All-Stars. And a pass comes off of a stick out in front and then still grabbed by Huron. And now Bush back skating will pass for Peterson. And a good job by Bistrup again to cut his man off. And that bouncing puck went right over the top of a bot stick and played by Dozark as he'll play it out of the zone. He was checked by Peterson. Now that puck will come back in the offensive zone for Huron, but right back out it comes to the neutral zone. Lead back over for Botts. He'll move it in 2-on-3. Botts with a shot save is made by Youngworth. As the puck will come to the near side. Off the boards, out to the blue line. It's going to be held in by the All-Stars for a moment, but it flutters its way into the neutral zone. Schweitzer stands up a man as Brecken Glanzer ran into him and took the worst of it. Keegan Kitts trying to move into the offensive zone, but that puck just a bit too far out of his reach. And now it's grabbed by the All-Stars, but Kitts will take his man down as he was able to step in front of Tage Carrillo. And now it's though the All-Stars back in the blue line moving in, and they just can't settle the puck down as Coughlin now will grab it for the Capitals. Calmly will pass it up for Kitts on the far side of the boards, flips it out of the zone, grabbed by the All-Stars and thrown right back in where it's gonna be taken by Andrew Coughlin as the All-Stars hit a tag back up. Coughlin gains the red line, he'll dump it in the zone with 11:05 remaining here in the first period. Bales comes out of his net to play it, and then the Capitals will get called for a penalty. And it will be the first penalty kill of the evening for the Capitals, and I believe it is Andrew Coughlin that will go for a rough. 11:01 remaining here in the first period. So Coughlin goes to the box, a rough against him. And the Huron All-Stars will have their first power play opportunity in the first Hermanson Endodontics penalty kill, which Capitals haven't been on a whole lot of penalty kills over the last several games, which also leads to the success of the Capitals, as that one will be fluttering out of play, and it will remain in the Huron All-Stars offensive end for the faceoff. You're listening to KCCR-FM Blount, a Riverfront Broadcasting Station. Drew McIntyre's back in the station. John Wickley here on a Friday evening, just past 9 o'clock. Glad you're with us on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports. Here on All-Stars on the power play, their first one of the night. Centering pass, that one was too hard for Bot to handle. Now it's Tim that will play it across. Trying to touch it was Buckland. It'll still go to the corner for Peterson. Again, trying to center one for Bot. Comes back over for Tim in the corner and played down into the corner behind the goal line. Ethan Bush will circle the wagons back out top of the point. Shot it square away, and it was off of a boot in front, and it went wide. Back out for Bush again at the blue line. He'll swing that one over, and that's a save again made by Youngworth. The rebound went to the corner, but still picked up by the All-Stars. 1:15 remain on the power play. Bush plays it down, looking for a bot, but it goes off of his stick, and then the Capitals are able to clear it. Jay Sanderson on the backhand will send it down the ice. Bales comes way out of his net to play it. Up ahead for Tim. And the All-Stars who are trying to get right back in the offensive zone will be unable to as the Capitals send it back all the way down again with 55 remaining on the power play. This will be grabbed now by Beck for a moment. Grady Botts will take it back over, and the All-Stars will try to move it back in the offensive zone. Devin Dodson was able to get a stick to it. Over to Anderson. That will clear the zone another time. The Capitals have done a good job of clearing the zone after a initial settling into the offensive zone on the power play for the All-Stars. This will be stolen away by Bistrup. He'll throw it down the ice again. He'll go after and chase it, and Bales comes out of his net and nearly made a faulty play, which could have led to the Capitals having a shorthanded break. But instead, it's back in the neutral zone, and now Grady Bott will pass it into the zone. That shot was off of a body, and then Youngworth got his stick on it. He threw his stick up in the air. It was redirected, and it was floating towards the net, and Youngworth just threw a stick at it and popped it in the air like a baseball bat. And it's played out of the zone. Now here is Jaron Beck that will move in. 2-on-1, shorthanded. That shot went wide. Maybe went off the goalpost. And as Coughlin will come out of the penalty box, Capitals kill off that first penalty against. Bouncing puck. It'll be played to the corner. It's grabbed by Mason Hunter. And as Hunter, he falls to the ice. A couple players tumbled down. Played back behind the net with 8:40 remaining here in the first period. There's a puck that's still in the corner, taken here by the Capitals and Corbin Bystrom. Make that, yeah, it is Corbin Bystrom. And then a pass up from Miller to Devin Dotson. And Dotson will move in. The puck goes off the skate as he was trying to get it around the defenseman. Jaron Beck with a nice back check as he steals the puck away. Took that one from Elliot Hartman. Now pass over for Miller. Trying to center one back, and it went off of a stick and went behind the net. Goes back over now for Beam. He shot that one square away, but that one was blocked by Hartman. Now it's a pass. There's a shot by Devin Dotson. That's a good look for the Capitals. Good pass from Miller to Devin Dotson. Had a clean look at the goalie just at the side of the circle, the faceoff dot. And a save made by Bales, who has made 4 of 5 saves so far in net with 8:02 remaining here in the first period. Faceoff to the right of Jack Bales. And it's almost Schweitzer that had it off the faceoff win. He almost took it away from Alex Timm. Now it'll be Dozark trying to swing one around in front. He'll fall to the ice, gets right back up. Schweitzer now will take it back over. He's behind the net. It's going to be almost taken by Dylan Dotson. Now the pass goes over for Coughlin. Coughlin waits his shot with a goalie screen, and it whistled wide to the blocker side, stick side of Jack Bales. Now it's Schweitzer again, centering one off the stick of Dylan Dotson. That would have been interesting if that had gone in, if they would have counted it or not. Wouldn't have been a distinct kicking motion, but he uses skate to try and stop it. As it comes out to the blue line and comes out of the zone, where it's going to be Beam that will swing it across ice, off the boards for Coughlin to pick up. He'll step up offensively. That shot and a save made by Bales. He turns the rebound to the corner. But it's still grabbed by the Capitals, where it's going to be Schweitzer centering one, and that one is Dylan Dotson that is stuffed at the post. Now it's Dozark backhand one. He still can't get that one to fall through. Dylan Dotson trying to get to the front, winds up with a slap shot, and a save is made. Actually, I think it went off of a body and went into the netting as he wound up the stick. I think some of it was trying to just get his stick free from being lifted and being tangled up. But his shot goes off of a body and goes into the netting. We get a whistle at 6:54 to go here in period number one. Still 1-0 in the American Family Insurance Brittany Schoffelbein scoreboard. Bouncing puck, Dylan Dotson again winds up for a slap shot, partially fanned on, and then it's going to be coming out in front of the net for the All-Stars to play and get out of the zone. The pass goes off of a couple of boards a couple different times, and it's grabbed by the Capitals. Well, they'll play it across, and they will ice it with 6:30 remaining here in the first period. So still 1-0. Barry Schweitzer, a minute and 44 seconds in to the first period, got the go-ahead goal, and that's all we've had so far in this first period, with just 6.5 minutes remaining in the first period. This will be a pass over. One-timer save is made. Puck is up high on the rebound, then trying to backhand it was Botts. That one-timer came from Peterson. And now it's Bott in the corner. We'll play it out to the blue line, but that's going to be off of a stick, and now it's going to be a race for it. And moving in the zone, trying to get a shot away as Kitz was partially hooked. There's a shot, then that one will be a save. And now we will get a whistle, and an unsportsmanlike penalty will come to Keegan Kitz with 6:02 remaining here in the first period. And so Kitz will also get a 10-minute misconduct. So Kitz is going to be in the penalty box for 2 and 10. And it is an unsportsmanlike and then a 10-minute misconduct on top of it with 6:02 remaining here in the first period. So it'll be just a 2-minute power play, but now Keegan Kitz will have to wait until the second period to come back into this game. As he might, we'll have to wait, maybe wait until about the 11-minute mark in that second period, as long as the All-Stars don't score the power play. There's a pass that comes in front, and it was intercepted by Jay Sanderson, who will throw it down. And the penalty killers have looked good in the first power play against. Hermanson Endodontics penalty kill goes back for a second time. And the Huron All-Stars are trying to tie this one up, as it's now taken again by Aiden Beam, who threw it all the way down. As it'll be played around Diego Colon, there we go. As that pass off the boards for Botts. Beck trying to push him away, but now it comes back for Colon, and his pass misses for Peterson. Grayson Hunsley will play it across. That will be played down, and it's now Beck that will move it in the zone. Short-handed, Capitals are thinking right now. Beck will stick handle around, and he'll just pass it all the way back out of the Capitals' blue line, where Jay Sanderson will grab it and kill more time off the penalty kill. This will be touched along by Devin Dodson into the offensive zone. Devin Dodson trying to go one-on-three right now. He nearly got a chance to go for that opportunity, but he was taken down, and Jaron Beck tried to raise his hand for the referee, but to no avail. And it'll be thrown down by Grayson Hunsley with 4:35 remaining here in the first period. Still 30 seconds to go on the power play. That pass misses for Mason Hunter. And now it's Jay Sanderson will throw it off the boards and back down again. The All-Stars cannot get their offense set up on the power play. This pass is going to be off of a stick, picked up by Devin Dodson. Trying to centering one for Beck. Instead, it comes back to Dodson off of a stick, and he'll just play it easily back out of the zone. This will be touched along. That'll be an offside. Devin Dodson, not a bad play there from Devin Dodson. Went off the linesman, so it was sitting right at the blue line. Devin Dodson knew he was offside. He just touched it. There is no forcible offside to force that puck drop to be all the way down. So instead, it is just an offensive or a neutral zone faceoff, and you get a clean line change on top of it. So good play by Devin Dodson, as Andrew Coughlin will throw it in from the blue line, and it'll go all the way down with 4:02 remaining. Asher Vandenbos, who was serving the penalty for Keegan Kitts, comes out of the penalty box, so good to the bench, and it's now 5-on-5 with 4:02 remaining here in the first period. This will be a puck that is controlled by the All-Stars after it was bounced around by a couple, about five different players had their sticks to it. And now it's here, Dozark again. Pass for Schweitzer. He'll circle around, his trying to get a shot free, pokes at it, trying to get it in front of the net. Stick lift, Dylan Dodson over there. Now it's grabbed by Schweitzer again. Schweitzer trying to find his way free to center or shoot the puck, unable to. Pass comes back out for Coughlin. Walks the line, that shot, and Bales saw it all the way through and will make the save with 3:28 remaining here in the first period. Face-off to the left of Bales. Offensive zone face-off for the Capitals. It's won by the All-Stars as it'll be played around, and it will come out of the zone. Ethan Bush now will race in the offensive end. Ethan Bush, he gets checked by three different players. Capitals are able to get the puck back in their own end of the ice as Coughlin tried to play it up, but it was intercepted, trying to center one for a one-timer for Peterson. When the puck was broken up by the Capitals, never got a shot on net. Now here is Schweitzer moving in. One hand on his stick, backhand pass in front, they score! Dylan Dodson makes it 2-0. And Barrett Schweitzer, one hand on his stick, got the backhand feed across, and Dylan Dodson was able to swipe it straight in. And for Dylan Dodson, his fifth goal of the season, and a 2-0 lead with 2:58 to go here in the first period. That was a beauty of a play. Moving in was Schweitzer and Dylan Dodson. Boy, this line that stays out there right now, they have been buzzing as Schweitzer lost his stick. He kicked it along. Puck will come back over to him. He's able to hold it for Dylan Dodson. Now it's Dozark with a penalty being called by the Huron All-Stars. Coughlin, his shot looking for a redirect. Schweitzer got his stick back and went off of his skates, though. Jackson Youngworth to the bench right now. It's a delayed penalty, so it's 6-on-5 attack. Coughlin, his throw into the net. There's a save made, and Huron finally touches up. And we get a whistle with 2:28 remaining in the first penalty against the Huron All-Stars. And we'll see who it is that will go to the penalty box. It will be number 5 in Skyler Casper. And it is a slashing call against Skyler Casper. And with 2:28 remaining, it is the first power play of the ball of the hockey game for the Capitals. But it's quickly cleared by the Huron All-Stars all the way down. 2-0 lead with 2:20 remaining here in period number 1. First power play opportunity for the Capitals. As Coughlin thought about a pass to Jaron Beck, but instead he'll pass all the way across for Devin Dotson. Pass across for Schweitzer on his stick. He scores! The feed went across from Dozark, and Baron Schweitzer makes it 3-0 with 2:03 remaining here in the first period. And a quick power play goal for the Capitals. And Schweitzer's got his second, 12th of the season now. Coughlin, who had that first pass, I believe it was a Dozark that had the feet across, and Schweitzer was in front. He made no mistake. He was never going to make a mistake about it. And now the referee talking with Youngworth. Not sure what the conversation is. But it will be, I believe everything's okay. It will be Corbin Bystrom now that has the puck in the Capitals end the ice. There's a shot by Bott that goes off of something and goes into the netting. And we get a whistle with 1:54 remaining here in the first period. So Keegan Kitsu in the penalty box with 6:02 remaining. His 10 minutes started with 4:02 remaining, and Jace Anderson is going to limp off the ice. He's struggling to Well, they're going to send him back out there. He can barely skate right now. I'm not sure what's going on here, but that Anderson can barely skate. He's coming off because he's hurt, but the referee is demanding him come back on the ice. All right, then. It is Riley Pfeiffer that will be able to pass it up and in the offensive zone as Keller Herman. And Pfeiffer along with Alex McIntyre. The pass over for Corbin Bystrom. Make that Devin Dotson. It was not Dozark, excuse me. And they're going to give Jackson Youngworth an assist as this pass will be over. And now we get a hand pass called against the Capitals with 1:24 to go here in the first period. The faceoff will come outside the offensive zone and in the. So Youngworth will get the assist. I thought it was Coughlin that made the pass, but they give Jackson Youngworth the point and that'll be his first varsity point. So the Capitals lead it 3-0 with 1:24 to go here in the first period. It is Corbin Bystrom here for Grayson Hunsley. Up ahead for Jaron Beck. Now we get an offside called against the Capitals, and it'll be a neutral zone faceoff again with 1:12 to go here in the first period. Luke Miller up with Mason Hunter, a pair of 10s. One much taller than the other one, as Grayson Hunsley will play it up for Miller. And the puck will come back to the neutral zone. And the All-Stars will start to move it in, but the stick of Corbin Bystrom is able to take the puck away. Capitals will come in onside. Jaron Beck will move it free. His backhander trying to come to the front of the net. Instead, it's grabbed by the All-Stars. And Huron will get to the center ice. Jaron Beck will play it across for Grayson Hunsley. 40 seconds to go here in the first period. It is now going to be taken by Devin Dodson up ahead for Jaron Beck. Beck trying to toe drag move, went off of a skate. And now is Devin Dodson moving back in. His centering pass goes over now for Beck. On the far side of the ice, Beck back down for Miller, and his pass comes right back to Beck, and his shot went wide. Trying to center one, went off the goalpost after it went off the stick of Bales. Down to 13 seconds to go. Make that 10 seconds to go now in the first period. Devin Dodson trying to center one for Miller. One maybe last chance for a shot here for the Capitals, but they will not get that shot away, and that will end the first period with the Wyatt Capitals leading 3-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schoeffelbein scoreboard, as we'll talk here with the head coach and Steve Steele with the 3-0 advantage right now with goals, two goals by Barrett Schweitzer and the other by Dylan Dodson. As Coach Steele will get his headset on, and Coach, for the first 17 minutes, a really good start for you guys.
Yeah, a lot of good things happening there. I think both special teams looked really good. I think we were pretty sound defensively, a couple little breakdowns there, but for the most part, it was a really good period.
Barrett Schweitzer got it started, minute 44 seconds in. His shot, he has been very confident with the puck on his stick, and he's made some really good and really good sharp shooting goals lately.
Yeah, anytime you shoot short side high, you got to be confident to shoot that. It's a really small pocket that's there, if it's there, and he's hit it. I think that's three in the last four games, I think, that he's hit it.
Well, then he scores another one, but Dylan Dodson also scores, returning from injury. And that line of Schweitzer, Dozark, and Dylan Dodson, they've been very, very impressed over the last couple games.
Yeah, they're relentless guys. They're kind of that gritty forechecking style line, and they're all over the puck, and they're all around the net, and they just keep working. And that's really starting to pay off, and they're putting the puck in the back of the net right now.
Well, you had two penalty kills to go against, but you only give up four shots in that first period. That's a good start, and for Youngworth, hasn't been tested. His four saves have been good saves, but nothing that's been a full test because the defense and the penalty kill has been so good in front.
Yeah, he's done a great job locked in. Again, we talked about this two weekends ago, I guess, at Sioux Center, that it can be a challenge when you're not seeing a shot all the time, and you've got some extended periods between shots, and he's just done a great job staying locked in, getting out, playing the puck when he can, and just staying engaged.
The adjustments going in the second period?
We have to stay out of the penalty box. We've gotten to work our penalty kill enough. We've done good at it, but we don't want to keep doing it. Other than that, I'd like us to see a little bit more shooting. 14 shots, I think we had a good amount there on that last power play. But I think that we're being a little too picky right now.
Jace Anderson, how's he doing? I know he had to, for some reason, stay on the ice after he was hurt. How's he doing?
He'll be all right. Block shot, awkward spot on your foot there. Just has to walk on it. He'll be all right.
Sounds good. Coach, appreciate the time. Good luck in the second, third period.
Thanks, John.
That is head coach Steve Steele, the Wyatt Capitals. The Caps lead at 3-0 at the end of the first period with the 14-4 in shots in favor of the Caps through that first 17 minutes. We will step aside. When we come back, we've got stats in the first intermission reports. You're listening to a Wyatt Capitals Hockey presented by Capital City 4, Lincoln and Toyota on Capital City Rock, and you're watching it on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
Quality replacement auto parts, look no further than Zander Auto Parts and Machine Shop in Pier. Zander's has been servicing the Pier area for over 40 years. Their professional parts techs can get you the parts you need and get you back on the road. Stop by Zander Auto Parts and Machine Shop at 500 West Sioux in Pier or call 224-9221. Zander's, your source for domestic and foreign auto parts and accessories.
Dano's Marine supports Oahe Capitals Hockey. Stop in and see the new owners, originally from Pier, Brandon and Amanda Larson. Dano's Marine technicians are here to help with all your motor needs. They can rig accessories and electronics in all brands of boats or get you into a new boat or pontoon. Dano's Marine, 916 Deadwood Street in Fort Pier. Don't forget to winterize your boats. Call Dano's Marine at 605-224-6612.
Verdig Electric has a long history of doing electrical work the right way. Economical service, professional work, and customer satisfaction is why they can say that. Verdig Electric can do residential, farm, and commercial projects. Doesn't matter if they are charged with new construction or a remodel project, they get it conducted. Contact the staff at Verdig Electric at 224-8684. They can light a spark into your next project. Ferning Electric, 224-8684.
What makes our business successful? Our people. Beck Motor Company and Peer takes great pride in our team, and we are looking to add to it. We currently have an opening for a full-time parts consultant. This individual works closely with our service department and collision center customers, as well as walk-in customers, getting them the parts and accessories they need. Experience a plus, but we'll train the right individual. Many benefits, including health insurance. Contact Steve Meyer at 224-5912.
Hello, I'm Pastor Jeff Lathrop of Pier First United Methodist Church, and I'd like to invite you to join us in person for worship on Sunday mornings at 8:30 a.m. or 11 a.m. You can also join us on Facebook Live or on KCCR 1240 a.m. or 98.9 FM for our Sunday morning broadcast at 11 a.m. Come worship with us at First United Methodist Church, where you will find open hearts, open minds, and open doors.
When you're looking for quality trash pickup services, look no further than Envirotech. 6 days a week, their trucks are on the road picking up trash, even holidays. They're also the place to contact for recycling services. Their friendly, professional staff is ready to assist with weekly pickups or even special pickups. Check out the website at envirotechwaste.com. Envirotech is locally operated. Call 224-4804. Envirotech Waste Services in Pierre. Proud to support high school athletics.
Hi, this is Luke Miller, and you're listening to Wahee Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back here, it is the 3-0 lead for the Wahee Capitals over the Huron All-Stars for the first 17 minutes of this hockey game. Barrett Schweitzer has scored twice, and a goal from Dylan Dotson in between those two goals has made it 3-0. Schweitzer's second goal came on the power play, and the Caps out shooting the Huron All-Stars 14-4 through the end of the first period. The Caps are 1-for-1 on the power play. Huron All-Stars 0-for-2 on the power play. Keegan Kitts will have another 3 minutes and 58 seconds. That's not right. 5 minutes and 58 seconds to go before he is able to come out of the penalty box, but it also has to wait for the next stoppage to come out of the penalty box after that first 5 minutes and 58 seconds are through of that, the 10-minute misconduct penalty that he got with his 2-minute unsportsmanlike penalty. So the Capitals, though, have that 3-0 lead and have been able to not so much do whatever they want, but they've been able to as Coach Steele said, maybe be a bit too passive and need to want to get more shots, because the Caps overall with 14 shots, they've got some really good looks, but maybe it's time to open up and fire away and see how many shots you can get overall against this goalie for the Huron All-Stars and really start to put this thing out of reach. And the Caps with that 3-0 lead have got that started, but want to continue that going into the second period. This is a big weekend for the Capitals. They've got the Brookings Rangers on Saturday, the Rushmore Thunder on Sunday. And right now, Rushmore and Brookings both playing. Rushmore in Watertown, Brookings playing in Sioux Falls West. We'll talk about those scores from across the state. We'll also get you set for the rest of this weekend, because the Capitals, we told you where the Capital boys are going to be playing, or they are playing here on Saturday and Sunday. We got the Capital girls tomorrow as well, tomorrow afternoon. So we will talk about all of that coming up as our first admission report continues. Back with more after this. You're listening to Hawaii Capitals Hockey, presented by Capital City for Lincoln and Toyota on Capital City Rock, and you're watching it on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
When you're in the high-quality replacement auto parts, look no further than Zander Auto Parts and Machine Shop in Pierre. Zander's has been servicing the Pierre area for over 40 years. Their professional parts techs can get you the parts you need and get you back on the road. Stop by Zander Auto Parts and Machine Shop at 500 West Sioux in Pierre or call 224-9221. Zander's, your source for domestic and foreign auto parts and accessories.
With any dream, the wind won't always be at your back. The sun won't always be shining, and some rain is going to fall. American Family Insurance is like a good, solid roof that you can trust to protect your biggest dreams. With plans that could save you up to 23% when you bundle your home and auto. Also, you can continue to dream fearlessly, no matter what comes your way. American Family Insurance.
Visit MFAM.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Contact the Brittany Shelfelbein Agency, LLC. 224-6627.
What makes our business successful? Our people. Beck Motor Company and Pier takes great pride in our team, and we are looking to add to it. We currently have an opening for a full-time parts consultant. This individual works closely with our service department and collision center customers, as well as walk-in customers, getting them the parts and accessories they need. Experience a plus, but we'll train the right individual. Many benefits, including health insurance. Contact Steve Meyer at 224-5912.
Pizza Ranch of Fort Pier is a proud supporter of the Oahe Capitals hockey. Bring your crew to the ranch. We have hot buffet options, including legendary pizza, the country's best chicken, savory sides, nutritious salads, and delicious desserts. Perched right on the river, our Fort Pier Pizza Ranch is only minutes away from the South Dakota State Capitol Building and from the Expo Center, home of the Oahe Capitals. The Pizza Ranch in Fort Pier.
Every day, you share personal information about yourself with others. You may write a check, charge fuel, rent a car, mail your tax returns, schedule a doctor's appointment, or post something on social media. Each transaction may share some sort of personal information, such as bank and credit card account numbers, social security number, name, address, or phone number. There are unscrupulous individuals, identity thieves, targeting these routine transactions, trying to gain your information to commit fraud. If you think somebody has stolen your identity, contact Consumer Protection at 1-800-300-1986.
The Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center in Pier is a proud supporter of Hawaii Capitals hockey. Ram Kota is more than just a place to stay. It's a full-service hotel where you'll arrive as a guest and leave as a friend. Enjoy our comfortable accommodations while you're in Pier. A full bar and restaurant, too. Best of luck to the Hawaii Capitals hockey teams. The support comes from your friends at the Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center. Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center, 920 West 2 Avenue in Pier. Give us a call at 605-224-6877.
Hi, this is Grayson Hunsley, and you're listening to Oahe Capitals Hockey on Capitals City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capitals City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back here, the Oahe Capitals lead at 3-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Shelfelbein scoreboard. Real quick, we'll go through scores right now. Rushmore Thunder up 7-0 over the Watertown Lakers right now, as it was 3 goals in the first, another 2 goals in the second, and 2 goals so far in the third, as they are in runtime and closing in on the end of that contest between the Rushmore Thunder and the Watertown Lakers. For the other game, it is a 3-0 lead for the Brookings Rangers over Sioux Falls West. As the Rangers will be in town tomorrow, Owen Schneider, Riley Lindstad, and Jacob Colley have the 3 goals between for the Brookings Rangers, who are out shooting Sioux Falls West at 20-14. Oahe Capitals girls, they will play tomorrow afternoon, 1:30 with coverage, or make that 1 o'clock with coverage around there, and 1:30 with puck drop. And then on Monday, there is a makeup game. The Oahe Capitals will travel to Brookings. That was the game originally scheduled for last Saturday that was postponed. They will play this coming Monday with puck drop at 4:45. We'll have coverage of that game around 4:15 and puck drop at 4:45 on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports. We've got the second period on its way next for you. The Oahe Capitals lead at 3-0 over the Huron All-Stars. Back after this, as you're listening to Hawaii Capitals Hockey, presented by Capital City for Lincoln and Toyota on Capital City Rock, and you're watching it on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
When you're in the need for high-quality replacement auto parts, look no further than Zander Auto Parts and Machine Shop in Pier. Zander's has been servicing the Pier area for over 40 years. Their professional parts techs can get you the parts you need and get you back on the road. Stop by Zander Auto Parts and Machine Shop at 500 West Sioux and Pier or call 224-9221. Zander's, your source for domestic and foreign auto parts and accessories.
The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites has Midwestern charm and unprecedented attention to detail that provides the perfect getaway. The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites provides a complimentary deluxe continental breakfast featuring hot waffles, biscuits, and gravy. They also have an indoor children's water playland, whirlpool and fitness center, and a beautiful backyard patio with seasonal fire pits. Everyone deserves a night away. Call 605-494-2582 to make your reservation today. The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites. Experience luxury in the heart of South Dakota.
HEE Corporation has been building South Dakota for nearly 60 years. For all your site work, construction, and crane needs, AGE is there for you. If you need a boat dock and dock lighting, AGE has what you need. Visit their website, agecorp.com, or give them a call at 223-2732. AGE Corporation, providing high-quality services without sacrificing safety. Visit agecorp.com or call 223-2732.
Weatherall Roofing and Insulation is a family-owned business that has served Central South Dakota for over 25 years. Weatherall Roofing and Insulation specializes in metal roof restorations and flat roof repair. They also offer the highest quality insulation using closed-cell polyurethane foam and blow-in fiberglass. For all your roofing or insulation needs, make Weatherall your first choice. And remember, just foam it.
Smart, rugged, capable. The Ford F-150 pickup at Capital City Ford. The Ford F-150 offers impressive power you need with the efficiency you want. It's loaded with intelligent technology. You can load up, tow, and work from about anywhere. Capital City Ford carries the newest model offering hands-free highway driving, towing tech, and heads-up display. Now, qualified buyers can purchase a new 2023 Ford F-150 for 1.9% APR for 72 months. Check out their full vehicle lineup at CapitalCityFord.com. Capital City Ford in Pierre.
Dr. Brian Hermanson serves Central South Dakota with specialty root canal treatment. Hermanson Endodontics aims to provide treatment that is not only comfortable, but has a quality-first emphasis. We believe that by preserving as much healthy tooth as possible, we can help you retain your natural teeth longer. This is accomplished with state-of-the-art three-dimensional imaging and the dental operating microscope to guide diagnosis and treatment. Ask your dentist if a root canal specialist is right for you. Hermanson Endodontics, 1709 North Lincoln Avenue in Pierre.
Hi, this is Barrett Schweitzer, assistant captain, and you're listening to Oahu Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back here, the Oahu Capitals and the Huron All-Stars, they will be making their way out of the locker room area here in just a moment and getting set for the start of period number two. We will start 5-on-5. Keegan Kitts will have to go back to the penalty box and will continue to serve in that last 5 minutes and 58 seconds of his misconduct before he is able and eligible to return on the next available whistle after those 5 minutes, near 6 minutes, have expired. Capitals are on their way out to the ice right now. And the Council attack from right to left. The Huron All-Stars from left to right in this second period, the period of the long change. But the Caps are looking to maybe take this into a, hopefully, you know, add on to this lead. You want to win every period, but here in this game, if you can double what you, or not double what you did, but you can add on to it another 3-0 in this second period, it'll help pick up the pace in the third period with the running time, and the Capitals would love to be able to get out of here. I don't say early, but it would be earlier than expected as we sit at 9:36 right now, and we're just now starting the second period between these two teams. Aiden Nozark will take the opening faceoff for the Capitals. Grady Bott will win it for the Huron All-Stars, and it'll roll all the way down on net, and Jack Bales will play it in the near side corner. That puck, though, taken by the Capitals for a moment, trying to center one for Schweitzer, who is on the hat-trick alert for another time. And the All-Stars now, Schweitzer had a piece of it, and then the stick will be able to block a pass for Bott, and it's played over, and it's moved in the zone by the Huron All-Stars. That pass, Peterson, and it will be taken by Aiden Dozark. Now in the corner, on his own end of the ice, off of a skate, comes out of the zone. Bouncing puck comes out. Now Dylan Dotson one-on-one moving in. Dylan Dotson moves in, trying to get to a backhand, and he scores! Makes it a 4-0 lead for the Capitals with 6:16 remaining here in the second period. And Dylan Dotson has his second of the game, his sixth of the year. I think somebody had said to shoot it, and he was patient enough. And this time, it was only 44 seconds into the period for the Capitals to score to make it 4-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard. He was able to wait long enough and get the backhand goal and put it into the yawning cage to make it 4-0. This puck will come out. Here's Barrett Schweitzer. Now he's got a breakaway. Schweitzer moving in. His shot, he scores! There's a hat trick for Barrett Schweitzer in a 5-0 lead. A minute and 5 seconds into the second period. And the Caps are one goal away from runtime. Schweitzer and Dylan Dotson, all 5 goals. Last two, both unassisted. And a 5-0 advantage. Schweitzer's tied the team high in goals now with 13. He and Jaron Beck both with 13 goals. Devin Dotson one behind them with 12. And the Capitals are 1 goal away from starting runtime. Now here's Schweitzer in back in. Offensive attack here for the Capitals. Schweitzer, Dozark. And it's going to be into the corner. Schweitzer. As Dozark now will play into the corner again. Puck will come free and it's going to come out of the zone as it's going to be picked up by Ryder Casper. Casper goes around Grayson Hunsley, but he falls down, blows a tire, and the puck will come out and into the netting. And we get a whistle with 15:21 to go here in the second period. So a 5-0 lead of the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard. Capitals have 2 shots and 2 goals to start this second period. And the faceoff will be to the left of Youngworth. It's won by the All-Stars. Played over into the corner, trying to center one is Huron, and now it's going to be taken back, and that puck will go off the stick of Brecken Glanzer and out of the zone. Grady Bott trying to bring it back in. He does onside. Bott with 6 goals in the season. Second on the team with Ethan Bush trying to center one over for Peterson. That puck was free, but Coughlin trying to pass it out to himself and get out of the zone. And it's intercepted by the All-Stars. That one trying to center one again. Bouncing puck goes just wide of the stick side of Youngworth. Trying to center one again. There's a shot up high, and Youngworth is able to make the catch up by his shoulder and hang on without a rebound or the puck dropping down. So we get a whistle with 14:44 to go here in the second period. Let's see. Strong look there from, or an odd shot from the All-Stars, and it nearly handcuffed Youngworth, but he's able to make the save, and now the puck will come out as Devin Dotson will try and get a breakaway. Dotson moving in, his shot, and that one shot it high. He's looking to make it 6-0. It was chasing him down, was Diego Colon, I believe it was, for the All-Stars, and forcing it. Dotson to maybe take a shot before he was ready to. Aiden Beam, a pass goes across for Andrew Coughlin in his own end. This will come to the bench, and it barely didn't go into the Capitals bench at the top of the boards. That was going right at John Kotelnik on the bench. Now it's Devin Dotson that will move it back in. He is hooked a bit. Play will continue. And now it's going to be for Jaron Beck. Beck behind the net. Pass goes over for Devin Dotson again. Plays it back over for Beck. Now he's behind the cage. Now Beck will circle around. He's going to be looking for the Michigan and unable to get that opportunity to get the Michigan. Then he'll run into Mason Hunter, and Jaron Beck will pick up a roughing call. And the Capitals will go back to the Hermanson Endodontics penalty kill. Third opportunity now for the Huron All-Stars with 13:44 to go here in the second period. And Keegan Kitts closing in on having the opportunity of coming out of the penalty box, but still got some time to sit in the box a little bit longer. So with 13:44 to go here in the second period, it is a offensive zone faceoff, as it will be won by the Huron All-Stars. Ethan Bush works it back out to the point here for the All-Stars. Leaves it at the blue line. Swings his stick at it to try and keep it in play. Schweitzer almost got away with the short-handed chance. That shot, Youngworth made the save. It squeaked free to his left, but it was able to go beyond the goal line away. And the Capitals are able to clear the zone. This will be lifted up high. Trying to jump at it and keep it in the zone was Dozark. Capitals are really thick and shorthanded right now. Grady Bott tried to leave it back. Instead, he's going to turn it over. And now Dozark will move one-on-one in. He'll shoot it from the blue line. That one went wide. It's picked up by Bush on the far side of the ice. And he'll leave it back behind the net. Comes back around over to the blue line where Corbin Bjestrom will pinch in. Schweitzer will pick it back up. He's trying to center one for Dozark, but that was grabbed by the All-Stars. And then it was a pass looking like it was going to be a pass from Bott. Now Tim will pass it across, and it'll be taken here by the All-Stars. As it will be an opportunity to try and get for the All-Stars. Moving in, shot save made by Youngworth. That one came from Bott. And this will be a puck that's loose. Barrett Schweitzer now for Bjestrom trying to clear the zone. The All-Stars in the midst of a change, and now it's Schweitzer. He'll move it one-on-one in, shorthanded. He'll get around. Schweitzer with a shot in that one. Save made by Bales. As it's now Dylan Dotson looking to attack shorthanded. He's got four different All-Stars around him as the Capitals are in the midst of a penalty kill change. Bjestrom now will play it back over for Herman. He'll play it across over for Dylan Dotson, who will swing it back in the zone. He's back at the blue line, moved in, trying to keep the puck around five different All-Star players. Dylan Dotson with a backhander and a save made by Bales. He went one on five with the All-Stars and still end up with a shot on goal. And Dylan Dotson then will steal a pass and it'll be moved back in the zone as it will be Jaren Beck that comes out of the penalty box. Asher Vandenbosch steps on the ice for him as the Capitals complete their change. Keller Herman, he's knocked off the puck. And then it will be flipped up into the zone by the Capitals, but iced by the Huron All-Stars with 11:22 to go here in the second period. And Keegan Kitts will come out of the penalty box and will rejoin the team. Faceoff will be to the left of Bales. It'll be Vandenbosch that will take the faceoff against Skyler Kasper. Faceoff is won by the Capitals and Vandenbosch. Now Vandenbosch will pick it back up at the blue line. Flutters one over for Beam, who will spin around to keep the puck in the zone. But then Beam lost the puck, and it will come out as it's to be played up. Moving it one back in was Micah Metter, but it's taken by the Capitals. Out of the zone it comes for Keller Herman. But at the Huron blue line, they will keep it in, keep possession of it. That pass comes out of the zone. Aiden Beam is pass over for Coughlin. Too strong for Vandenbosch. Grabbed by Diego Colin. That pass was tipped as Pfeiffer got a piece of it. And now it's an intercepted pass as Beam will move it in. Beam tries to swing wide in. Looking for a centering pass for Vandenbosch, but just couldn't quite get it over to him. It was intercepted by the All-Stars and then dumped in the zone. 10:22 to go here in the second period. Capitals still lead it 5-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard. It is Herman that moves it in the zone. Keller Herman with a shot, and that one whistles high. Maybe get a piece of it was Bales. Beam will hold the zone right before he makes the change. Capitals will make a overhaul change right now with only Coughlin still on the ice. Devin Dotson will take the puck away. His shot in a right pad save made. The rebound was juicy, but Jaren Beck couldn't Luke Miller couldn't get over to it first. At the blue line, it'll be coming out of the zone. The Capitals will have to tag up as it went back in. Then a pass over was off the stick of Devin Dotson, nearly intercepted, and it will make its way back into the Huron zone or Huron offensive zone. Bott will leave it for Bush. That shot, and the goal scorer for the All-Stars shot it wide of Youngworth. Now a race for it. No icing, and puck's not going to get there, and it's going to be played around by Brecken Glanzer. And then that shot went off the glass as it comes back to the blue line where it's taken by the All-Stars. It'll be moved back in by Bush. His shot saved made on the glove from Youngworth, and now it's played back up in Devin Dotson as he just couldn't quite get it over and around the defender in Alex Tim. And now it's back in. Tim moves it in. That pass over for Bott. That shot in a blocker saved by Youngworth. The puck is still free in front, and it's cleared by the Capitals and out of the zone. It was actually number 16 and Jonas Buckland that had moved into the offensive end for the All-Stars. Nice play by Jaren Beck with a toe drag move. Now he'll step through two defenders and moving in the offensive end where Devin Dodson will pick it up in the corner. Dodson will stop in the corner. That pass over for Hunsley, and that one will miss, and it goes all the way down the ice where Youngworth will come out to play it. He has made five saves in net so far in this second period. It was four shots in the first for the All-Stars, now five shots so far for the Huron All-Stars. As the pass will come over, and now it'll be taken by Hunsley. His pass is intercepted, stays in the offensive end, but Dozark's able to corral the puck for the Capitals. Now it's going to be a shot that went wide. Youngworth didn't see where it went to, and now we're going to get a penalty again on the Capitals. And it will be a hooking call against Jace Anderson. So the Capitals will have their fourth Hermanson Endodontics penalty kill. Capitals have been pretty good over the last several games of taking a few penalties, but here in this game, this is their fourth penalty kill of the game, fifth penalty overall. Well, you'd have to do a little bit of some digging, but I'm not sure that the Capitals have been called for five penalties in a combined over the last three games. Here's a shot that is a nice stick by Corbin Bistrom. Make that Grayson Hunsley, as it was, I believe, Grady Bott, who was wide open in front, and Hunsley was able to reach out his stick to block the shot, so it never got to Youngworth, and it went over the top of the netting and out of play with 7:53 to go here in the second period. It is Dozark. Schweitzer trying to chip it out of the zone and chase after it. Now Dozark will kick it along, and it's going to be Schweitzer that will move it back in the zone. Schweitzer with a shot that whistles wide, and it comes all the way out of the zone, but the Capitals will take some more time off the penalty kill. All the way down it comes. They were trying to pass it to Schweitzer, but just missed him. And now it's going to be taken by number 19 and Jack Peterson. Peterson moves it back in. That shot was off the stick of the Capitals. It's actually Dylan Dodson that got called for the penalty, not Jace Anderson. So Dylan Dodson will have his first penalty. But an offensive, here comes the Huron All-Stars moving back in the offensive end on the penalty kill. But now it's going to be a break for Devin Dodson. Devin Dodson moving in, wide open the breakaway, and he shot it wide. And then blowing a tire. Now Schweitzer trying to pick it back up. He has tripped, so the All-Stars will get called for a penalty whenever they touch the puck, and it will be Bott that will pass it along. Devin Dodson was maybe late getting onto the ice on the change, which also helped the Capitals because Barrett Schweitzer was able to find Devin Dodson wide open at the blue line. As it will be number 8 in Glanzer that will go to the penalty box and end the power play for the Huron All-Stars with 6:49 to go here in the second period. Got called for the trip. And a 4-on-4 we play for 45 seconds, and then a brief power play for the Capitals. A little over a minute. Cameron Lee, a pass goes over for Coughlin. Got Devin Dodson and Jaron Beck on the ice right now. Capitals are feeling a little bit more like they're on a power play right now with it being 4-on-4. Jaron Beck, pass over for Coughlin, leaves it back over for Beck. Beck moving in. Nice move around. His shot never got through. Might have went off of Devin Dodson. And now it's going to be Coughlin that will pick up the blue line. Pass goes across for Beck. Beck in the near side boards. He'll circle and spin. Moves it back into the slot. That shot off the goalpost. Beck trying to buy a goal right now. He's had a couple of really good looks. 4 seconds to go before the Capitals take the power play. There's a shot by Lee. Save is made. And at the moment the referee blew the whistle, Dylan Dodson comes out of the penalty box. So the Capitals will have a minute and 10 seconds of a power play. The referee getting a little bit of some medicine. Something's not right with one of our officials here tonight. So he's getting some medicine and a drink of water. Hopefully he'll be feeling okay. The faceoff will come to the right of Jack Bales. And Jaron Beck will take the faceoff. It is the second power play of the day for the Wyatt Capitals. They are 1-for-1. Barrett Schweitzer scored the power play goal. That came with 2:03 to go in the first period. So now the Caps will have their opportunity on the second power play. And if they do cash in the next minute and 10 seconds, they will start run time with just under 6 minutes to go here in the second period. It is Devin Dodson. His pass will go over for Coughlin in the corner. At the point, Coughlin will try and throw one to the corner. That puck was blocked by one of the Huron players and trying to clear it out. Dozark will keep it in. That shot was seen all the way through by Bales. He'll make the glove save and a whistle and an offensive zone faceoff here for the Capitals again, as that will be to the right of Bales another time. 5:42 to go here in period number two. Capitals are trying to make this a six-goal lead as Beck will win the faceoff and will shoot it backhanded to the net off the faceoff win. It went wide, and the All-Stars are able to clear the zone, where it's now Dozark at his own blue line. His pass over for Coughlin with 37 seconds to go here in the power play. Coughlin being hounded by number 19 and Jack Peterson. As Beck now lost the puck to Grady Bott, who will push it back into the Capitals end of the ice. Youngworth touches it with his stick, and now it's going to be Coughlin that will leave it over for Dozark. Dozark, his pass over for Beck, right back to Dozark, a little give and go, back to Beck again, right back in the zone, right in the middle of the ice, and back trying to circle one in front, he scores! Got to the forehand, he makes it 6-0, a power play goal for Jaron Beck, his team-leading 14th goal of the season. And it's 6-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard, and the Caps have run time against the All-Stars. Ian Dozark, that might be another point for Jackson Youngworth, too. I believe he was the second to last to touch it. A couple of passes from Dozark and Beck to each other. I think Youngworth might get a second assist here tonight. That puck will be behind the nets. Again, we are in run time for the final 5 minutes of the second period. Alex McIntyre with it for the Capitals. His centering pass. That one is broken up to Riley Pfeiffer. Pfeiffer a pass to make that McIntyre pass over. And then we get a whistle. Coughlin will get the secondary assist. And as the clock continues, it was Miller that had the good look in front. Couple of passes from Pfeiffer, McIntyre, and Miller. As the puck will be played behind the net, it is McIntyre to pick it up. Alex McIntyre trying to center a pass. Puck is still free, and McIntyre will play it back over for Bystrom. Now back down for McIntyre off of his stick. Pfeiffer plays it back over for McIntyre. He's got a lot of space and time. His centering pass for Bystrom, who was cutting to the net, was broken up. Bystrom will get the puck back, and now it's going to be taken over. That's pass from Pfeiffer to McIntyre. Save is made, and then kicked by Pfeiffer into the corner. That was a good pass from Bystrom to Pfeiffer, and a good look for McIntyre. Miller almost lost the puck. Now it's Bystrom again. Capitals are buzzing, and a save is made by Bales to slow things down but not stop the clock with now 3:25 to go here in the second period. So as long as Huron does not pull within four, the runtime will continue. And the Capitals, they still got another period to go, but have done their part through nearly two periods, to win their fifth straight game. Bridger Babcock will play it behind the net for Keller Herrmann, trying to center one, but that goes off of the netting behind the net, the actual goal net, not the netting that holds the puck in play. That is Devin Dodson now that will circle around for Keller Herrmann. His shot pass, it was off of a stick, and it went back in front of the net where it was taken by the All-Stars, but not clear. Devin Dodson trying to center one over. That's going to be intercepted by the All-Stars, and now it's back in the offensive end for Casper. Ryder Casper brought it in the zone with 2:28 to go here in the second period. Puck is free into the corner. It's grabbed by Herrmann. Then he turns it over in a shot that went wide from Skyler Casper. You have Ryder Casper and Skyler Casper out on the lines right now for the All-Stars. Keller Herrmann moves it back in the offensive end. His pass over. And Beck, Devin Dodson trying to center one. Capitals are being very passive right now, which, again, they don't need to score up 6-0. Trying to be a little bit, I wouldn't say too cute with anything, but being really fine with everything. As Bystrom will move it up the zone. That's tipped by Beck right at the red line, and it will be an icing. But that's really at this point, while the Capitals would love to have that offensive zone attack again, don't have to worry about it so much with the fact that the clock is continuing to run and the Capitals up 6-0. More time comes off the clock and you get more standing around, which will help save the legs going into Saturday and Sunday's game. As this will be coming out of the zone, Barrett Schweitzer will try and play it. Schweitzer, he was able to cut free. His shot and a save is made by Bales. He failed the first chance and was able to actually probably get a better shot that second time. Dylan Dotson, he's on hat trick watch as well. Trying to center one, went off of a skate. And it will be played by the Huron All-Stars out to the blue line where it's held in by the Capitals. Aiden Beam got pinned to the boards, but he was able to hold the zone. Chopping at it is Schweitzer to hold it in. Bouncing puck eventually taken by the All-Stars in the neutral zone. And another good stick there from the Capitals and Aiden Dozark. Dozark will settle things down here with 40 seconds. The All-Stars move back in the neutral zone. Dozark's got all kinds of time. His pass for Dotson on the tape. Goes back across for Dozark as he moves it back in. And then Dozark can't go between the legs of Buckland. And he was able to, though, pin him to the boards where referee gets spun out. And now we get a whistle coming up. We're going to get a penalty coming up against the Hawaii Capitals. And it will be Aiden Dozark that will go to the penalty box with 18.1 to go. So again, back to the Hermanson Ododonics penalty kill. But the referee, both referees put their arms up at different times. Well, it's head contact, so it's 2 and a 10. Well, Dozark, he's about to leave the ice, but he does not have to leave the ice. As Vandenbos will serve the penalty. It was not just a rough, it was head contact. So it'll be the fifth power play now for the Huron All-Stars. They're 0 for 4. 10 seconds to go in the period. And it will be a huge hit from number 19 in Jack Peterson. The puck comes out of the zone. And that will end the second period. So a 6-0 lead for the Hawaii Capitals. As Dylan Dotson with a little bit of a push at the end of that period to Jack Peterson, but that ends the second period with the Capitals up 6-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Shufflebine scoreboard. We'll try and talk here with Steve Steele, the head coach of the Capitals, but making sure that everybody makes their way to their respective benches. I think we will talk with Coach John Kotilnik at the end of the second period. And Coach, through two periods, got a 6-0 lead. Been able to score twice on the power play, 2 for 2 on the power play. Your thoughts through the first 34 minutes of this hockey game?
We just got to play smart. We got two more games tomorrow. We want all our guys ready for tomorrow, so we got to really minimize the penalties we're taking.
So far, again, 2 for 2 in the power play. This power play has looked good over the last several games, over the last couple of weeks. What's been a big reason why this power play has been so good?
Just really focusing on slowing the puck down. And once we get into the zone, slow it down, look for the passes, look for the open guys and get shots on net. Good quality shots, not just throwing the puck at the net.
10 saves so far for Jackson Youngworth. The goalies have played well over the last couple of weeks, but for Youngworth as well, he's been tested. He was tested a little bit more that second period with some higher quality chances. What have you seen from him in net and for these goalies in net?
You know, I really like Jackson as a goaltender. He's he's come a long way, and getting him ice time like this in these kind of games and getting him some varsity shots is really important for his development. So he's developing just like we hoped he would be and know he could do.
Well, I know you kind of mentioned it a little bit too, but the adjustments going in the third period to finish off this win, because obviously you got the run time going, so that helps. But how do you finish off this win, whether it be 6-0, whether it be 8-0, whatever it might be, how do you finish off this win in the right way?
Just, again, reiterating, be smart to our kids. Just don't take stupid penalties. Don't take any penalties. If you get a penalty, skate straight to the box. These refs aren't having any of the back talk, so just making sure our guys play smart.
Well, Coach, I appreciate the time, and good luck in the third period. That is Jack Katilnik, who it was I don't think he was very amused to be talking to me right now, and I say that with knowing Jack Katilnik and that he is a very good guy, but likes to give me a little bit of a hard time. But the Capitals have a 6-0 lead through the two periods, with goals in that second period by Dylan Dotson, Barrett Schweitzer, and Jaron Beck to make it a 6-0 score at the end of two periods. You are listening to KCCR FM Blount, a Riverfront Broadcasting Station. We've played two periods. We're just past 10 o'clock. We've got your second intermission report after this. You're listening to Hawaii Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock. You're watching it on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
Imagine your backyard turned into an outdoor oasis. Hi, this is Jason with Leisure Palace. Imagine sliding into a hot spring spa and having the jets pulsate and rejuvenate your body, then take a few steps into your own outdoor pool, swimming and enjoying time with family and friends. At Leisure Palace, we have a great selection of spas, pools, and many other items. The guaranteed lowest prices and your oasis for family fun and relaxation. Leisure Palace of Pier.
Ferdig Electric has a long history of doing electrical work the right way. Economical service, professional work, and customer satisfaction is why they can say that. Ferdig Electric can do residential, farm, and commercial projects. Doesn't matter if they are charged with new construction or a remodel project, they get it conducted. Contact the staff at Ferdig Electric at 224-8684. They can light a spark into your next project. Ferdig Electric, 224-8684.
AGE Corporation has been building South Dakota for nearly 60 years. For all your site work, construction, and crane needs, AGE is there for you. If you need a boat dock and dock lighting, AGE has what you need. Visit their website, agecorp.com, or give them a call at 223-2732. AGE Corporation, providing high-quality services without sacrificing safety. Visit agecorp.com or call 223-2732.
With any dream, the wind won't always be at your back, the sun won't always be shining, and some rain is going to fall. American Family Insurance is like a good, solid roof that you can trust to protect your biggest dreams. With plans that could save you up to 23% when you bundle your home and auto. Also, you can continue to dream fearlessly, no matter what comes your way. American Family Insurance.
Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, assigned its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Contact the Brittany Shelfelbein Agency, LLC. 224-6627.
The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites has Midwestern charm and unprecedented attention to detail that provides the perfect getaway. The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites provides a complimentary deluxe continental breakfast featuring hot waffles, biscuits, and gravy. They also have an indoor children's water playland, whirlpool and fitness center, and a beautiful backyard patio with seasonal fire pits. Everyone deserves a night away. Call 605-494-2582 to make your reservation today. The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites. Experience luxury in the heart of South Dakota.
Refined design. Remarkable capabilities. The Ford Edge at Capital City Ford delivers everyone and everything in style and comfort. Bold and aggressive on the outside, lavish with lots of tech on the inside. This SUV does a whole lot more than haul groceries. Travel with confidence when purchasing your all-new Ford Edge from Capital City Ford. And for a limited time, qualified buyers can purchase at 0.9% APR for 60 months. Check out their full vehicle lineup at CapitalCityFord.com. Capital City Ford in Pier.
Hi, this is Spencer Anderson, and you're listening to Hawaii Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back here to the Expo Center, it is a 6-0 lead for the Hawaii Capitals through the two periods. Three goals in the second period. Dylan Dotson, Barry Schweitzer, and Jaron Beck. Even strength goals for Dylan Dotson, Barry Schweitzer that came around 20 seconds apart, 19 seconds to be in fact, between the two those two goals, and they both came a minute and 5 seconds into the second period. And then with 4:58 remaining in the second, it was Jaron Beck to score on the power play from Aiden Dozark and Andrew Coughlin. A 6-0 lead for the Capitals through two periods as they are 2-for-2 on the power play and still have a minute and 42 seconds on the penalty kill to try and go 5-for-5 on the penalty kill in this game. Runtime has started, and the Hawaii Capitals will be looking for an opportunity here in the in this third period to finish out this opportunity, finish this game, and get the early win against the Huron All-Stars. We will step aside, and we'll come back with the score updates from around the state. You're listening to Hawaii Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock, and you're watching it on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
Wagner Auto Headquarters. Now is the time to order your new Buick, GMC, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram vehicles, plus a good selection of certified pre-owned vehicles. They'll take care of you after the sale with a full-service parts and auto body shop with trained technicians, along with a friendly financing team that'll work with you to find the best deal and one that'll fit your budget. Wagner Auto is your local full-service family-owned dealership for over 115 years. WagnerAuto.com. That's WagnerAuto.com.
Pizza Ranch of Fort Pier is a proud supporter of the Oahe. Bring your crew to the ranch. We have hot buffet options, including legendary pizza, the country's best chicken, savory sides, nutritious salads, and delicious desserts. Perched right on the river, our Fort Pier Pizza Ranch is only minutes away from the South Dakota State Capitol Building and from the Expo Center, home of the Oahe Capitals. The Pizza Ranch in Fort Pier.
Dr. Brian Hermanson serves Central South Dakota with specialty root canal treatment. Hermanson Endodontics aims to provide treatment that is not only comfortable, but has a quality-first emphasis. We believe that by preserving as much healthy tooth as possible, we can help you retain your natural teeth longer. This is accomplished with state-of-the-art three-dimensional imaging and the dental operating microscope to guide diagnosis and treatment. Ask your dentist if a root canal specialist is right for you. Hermanson Endodontics, 1709 North Lincoln Avenue in Pier.
With any dream, the wind won't always be at your back. The sun won't always be shining, and some rain is going to fall. American Family Insurance is like a good solid roof that you can trust to protect your biggest dreams. With plans that could save you up to 23% when you bundle your home and auto. Also, you can continue to dream fearlessly, no matter what comes your way. American Family Insurance.
Visit mfam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Contact the Brittany Shelfelbein Agency, LLC, 224-6627.
Hi, this is Devin Dotson, and you're listening to Oahe Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back here, the UI Capitals lead at 6-0 at the end of two periods. Real quick, score updates. We said it was about to be final. Rushmore Thunder, they do win 7-0 over the Watertown Lakers earlier tonight. It is also a final. Brookings gets the win over Sioux Falls West on the road as they win 7-3 over the Sioux Falls West Flyers, scoring 4 third-period goals. Sioux Falls West was down 3-0 after 2, made it 3-2 about the midway point of that third period. But then 4 straight goals for the Brookings Rangers, Talon Hyde, Jacob Colley, and then make that 2 straight goals, make it 5-2. Sioux Falls West made it 5-3 before Colley and Harris, Jay Harris, would score to make it 7-3. It was Sioux Falls West going 1-for-2 in the power play, and Brookings going 1-for-1 on the power play. So not a whole lot of penalties between those two teams in Sioux Falls from that game tonight. Capitals with a 6-0 lead here at home. They're trying to kill off their fifth penalty of the night to start this third period as we head to the third, and we'll have the third period for you next. The Hawaii Capitals and the Huron All-Stars, 6-0 lead for the Caps. Back with the third period after this here on Capital City Rock. You're watching it on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
Imagine your backyard turned into an outdoor oasis. Hi, this is Jason with Leisure Palace. Imagine sliding into a hot spring spa and having the jets pulsate and rejuvenate your body, then take a few steps into your own outdoor pool. swimming and enjoying time with family and friends. At Leisure Palace, we have a great selection of spas, pools, and many other items. The guaranteed lowest prices and your oasis for family fun and relaxation. Leisure Palace of Pier.
Weatherall Roofing and Insulation is a family-owned business that has served Central South Dakota for over 25 years. Weatherall Roofing and Insulation specializes in metal roof restorations and flat roof repair. They also offer the highest quality insulation using closed-cell polyurethane foam and blow-in fiberglass. For all your roofing or insulation needs, make Weatherall your first choice. And remember, just foam it.
What makes our business successful? Our people. Beck Motor Company in Pierre takes great pride in our team, and we are looking to add to it. We currently have an opening for a full-time parts consultant. This individual works closely with our service department and collision center customers, as well as walk-in customers, getting them the parts and accessories they need. Experience applies, but we'll train the right individual. Many benefits, including health insurance. Contact Steve Meyer at 224-5912.
When you're looking for quality trash pickup services, look no further than Envirotech. 6 days a week, their trucks are on the road picking up trash, even holidays. They're also the place to contact for recycling services. Their friendly, professional staff is ready to assist with weekly pickups or even special pickups. Check out the website at envirotechwaste.com. Envirotech is locally operated. Call 224-4804. Envirotech Waste Services in Pierre. Proud to support high school athletics.
Dr. Brian Hermanson serves Central South Dakota with specialty root canal treatment. Hermanson Endodontics aims to provide treatment that is not only comfortable, but has a quality-first emphasis. We believe that by preserving as much healthy tooth as possible, we can help you retain your natural teeth longer. This is accomplished with state-of-the-art three-dimensional imaging and the dental operating microscope to guide diagnosis and treatment. Ask your dentist if a root canal specialist is right for you. Hermanson Endodontics, 1709 North Lincoln Avenue in Pierre.
The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites has Midwestern charm and unprecedented attention to detail that provides the perfect getaway. The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites provides a complimentary deluxe continental breakfast featuring hot waffles, biscuits, and gravy. They also have an indoor children's water playland, whirlpool and fitness center, and a beautiful backyard patio with seasonal fire pits. Everyone deserves a night away. Call 605-494-2582 to make your reservation today. The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites. Experience luxury in the heart of South Dakota.
Hi, this is Riley Pfeiffer, and you're listening to Oahe Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back here, we are set for the third period of the Oahe Capitals. Have a 6-0 lead. Runtime will get going in this third period as well. The Capitals will have to kill off a minute and 42 seconds of their fifth penalty kill of the evening, and the Caps will be looking for that penalty kill to close out that fifth one against, but also then get themselves back to 5-on-5 and finish out the night against the Huron All-Stars. Aiden Dozark and Keegan Kitts have two penalties against, so they have to be careful not to get a third one. Dylan Dotson has two goals, and that's where you don't want to have to be careful. You want him to get his third goal and pick up a hat trick, as Barrett Schweitzer already has a hat trick in this game. So we are set for the third period, 5-on-4 to start this third period. 17 minutes are on the clock as minute 42 of a power play. We're underway to start the third period as the Caps lead at 6-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard. This will be in the offensive zone. Ethan Bush, he's got 14 goals so far in the season. The All-Stars are looking to just get on the board here on this power play. Bush circles the wagon. That shot, that one whistled wide. Maybe in a piece of it was Youngworth. He's made 10 saves so far in net through two periods. Capitals had just 10 shots in that second period, but were able to score three times on those 10 shots, out shooting here on 24-10. This will be sent all the way down the ice by the Capitals as the first minutes nearly gone by here in the third period with 58 seconds to go on the power play. Peterson would moved it in, but he moved it in offside as Bott will have to circle back around. And a faceoff will be coming just outside the Capitals' blue line. With 40 seconds and counting to go on the power play and under 16 to go in the third period. Dylan Dotson will take the face off. He'll take it against Elliot Hartman, and it's won by the All-Stars. Diego Colon will throw it in the zone for the All-Stars, and it's swung around and out of the zone by Cameron Lee, all the way back down again with 18 seconds to go on the power play for the Huron All-Stars. And Huron will move it into the neutral zone. And Cologne another time here for the All-Stars. Trying to dump it in, went off the linesman. Still picked back up by Huron as Hunter will give it back over for Buckley, Bucklin, and it will be taken by Herman, who will send it down. Penalty expires. Vanden Bosch will come out of the penalty box. And Dozark's 10 minutes starts now. He'll be able to come back with 5 minutes to go in the third period. As it will be Hunter that will intercept, Mason Hunter that is, and intercepted the pass and threw it back in the zone where it's grabbed by the Capitals. That pass is broken up, and that'll come out by the Capitals where it's taken by the All-Stars. And then it's Huron again, starting to move it back in the zone was Tage Carrillo, but it'll come back out. Herman will send it into the neutral zone. Played a lot in center ice right now in this third period. Here's a shot that goes wide. That one came from Skyler Casper. As it comes back to the blue line where Alex Tim is able to hold it in. Around it goes for Bridger Babcock. As Babcock will throw it off the boards, but it's controlled by Huron. And then the puck will go into the netting and we get a whistle. And when the clock continues to roll here with 14:10 to go in the third period. We'll have the Pizza Ranch post-game show coming up after we are done here. We'll recap the game quickly, have a quick conversation with Coach Steve Steele, and then we'll be back here on the air about 14 hours from now. Well, by the time we get off the air, as Devin Dotson will take the puck here for the Capitals. He'll move it in the offensive end. He hit the turnbuckle on the Huron bench. Thankfully, there's some padding over there with that where the glass starts. And he's able to bounce right back up. That centering pass, there is Jaron Beck. You had it square away, but a save made by Jack Bales, his first of the third period with 13:20 to go here in the third. Brookings Rangers are in town tomorrow night in boys varsity. We'll have coverage around 6:30. We'll make that 6:45. And a puck drop will be about 7:15. As Bridger Babcock again, that shot and a save made by Bales. Another whistle with 13:05 to go. But before we have that varsity game, the boys' varsity game, we've got the girls' varsity game against the Mitchell Marlins. The Wyatt Capitals will be hosting the Mitchell Marlins. Marlins at 6-3-1, and the Capitals at 6-2-1. They are the two that have been ties with each other, as that one will go all the way down, as it'll be played by the here on All-Stars. Out to the blue line it comes for the All-Stars, still here for Huron. There's a shot that went wide. Peterson, I think maybe Youngworth end up with a save as well. Somebody lost their stick. Peterson took the stick out of, almost looked like he took the stick out of the hands of Corbin Biestrom, as it'll be in the near side boards where it's grabbed by Devin Dotson and it will come out to the neutral zone. That pass will be fanned on by Brecken Glanzer. And it will be Glanzer that will play it around the boards. That one a pass over, trying to center one. Instead, it was intercepted by Huron. And it will come free in the neutral zone where Grady Bott will take it. Bott overskated it, and that'll be offside. So go back to it again. The White Capital girls will take on the Mitchell Marlins. 1:30 for puck drop. So we'll have a split doubleheader of games tomorrow, 1:30 and 7:15, with the scheduled puck drops between the two. Both games will be on Capital City Rock and also on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports. Rushmore Thunder, who will play Watertown again tomorrow, will be then in town Sunday afternoon. There's a centering pass over, and Kitts might have partially failed on the shot, and a save made by Jack Bales. And we get a whistle with 11:18 to go and counting here in the third period. But it'll be a 4 o'clock puck drop for the Sunday game between the Capitals and the Rushmore Thunder to close out the weekend. However, we'll not close out the consecutive days of games, as there's a centering pass that went off the stick of Schweitzer. He tried to redirect it in, but he never got it to the net. Now it's picked back up by Dylan Dawson. His shot looking for the hat trick and a save made by Bales. And a whistle with 10:45 to go here in the third period. The Capitals and Brookings Rangers girls varsity will be played Monday evening by the time that we get started, with puck drop at 4:45, pretty much Monday evening. But we'll have that game for you on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports. There's a centering pass by Schweitzer. Dylan Dawson never got a shot away. The puck will come out to the blue line, or it's taken by the Huron All-Stars. So four straight days of Hawaii Capitals hockey here on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports. I don't know if that's really ever been the case, to have four straight days of hockey. State tournaments are all three straight days, but I just don't know if I have not called a hockey game on a Monday afternoon or Monday evening. There's a shot by Kitts and a save made by Bales. So we'll break a record for consecutive days of calling hockey on the radio and on YouTube here in South Dakota, at least for us, as Schweitzer, he'll circle the wagons, makes a nice sidestep move, and then this shot was blocked. Schweitzer will pick it back up and will leave it for Dylan Dawson in the corner on the far side. Now Dylan Dawson starts to walk it in. He's looking for the hat trick. Maybe want to be a little bit, keep it on his stick a little bit more, trying to get shots away. This will be touched by Bales back behind the net for Huron to take, although it's grabbed by the Capitals. And Schweitzer, as he lost the puck, didn't go with him, and it goes all the way down, and an icing called against the All-Stars, and a whistle with 9:10 to go here in the third period. So an offensive zone faceoff for the Capitals again, as they lead it 6-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard. Faceoff will be to the left of Bales. Asher Vandenbos will take the faceoff. It is won by the Capitals. Here is Grayson Hunsley winds up with a shot that went wide to the glove side of Bales. Centering pass looking for Pfeiffer was Luke Miller, but that is instead broken up. And the puck will come out of the zone, and now here is Grady Bott moving in. Bott trying to center one over for Bush. Now it's back the other way, and Asher Vandenbos will bring it into the zone. He is checked hard into the boards by Brecken Glanzer. And now Bush out of the Huron zone, flips it high off the glass, and in the offensive end where Bott was trying to take it, now it's going to be Peterson. We'll give it back over to Bott, instead intercepted by the Capitals. But it comes back to the corner and played back around, where it's grabbed by Peterson, over skates the puck. And Miller leaves it for Vandenbos. Up ahead for Pfeiffer. Two on two in the zone for the Capitals. Pfeiffer lost it in his skates, trying to center one over. That puck was still loose. Vandenbos couldn't find where it was at. But now it's Bush moving back in the other way. Bush trying to find his way to get a shot. Centering pass comes in front. It's loose, and it comes back into the blue line. There's a shot that was blocked by the Capitals. Still loose. There's another shot that was blocked. Youngworth moving left and right, trying to find where the puck's at. Maybe got to stick to it, but it's not out of the zone. There's a shot that goes wide to the blocker side, the stick side of Youngworth. Then a fend on shots. Pfeiffer was trying to take it out of the zone, then flipped high at center ice by Vandenbos. That will get the chain for the Capitals with 7:17 remaining here in the third period. Capitals lead it 6-0. Nearly stolen. Now it's a 2-on-0. Devin Dodson in. Pass goes back to Devin Dodson. And a goal scorer, Keller Herman, gives it back over to Devin Dodson to get the goal. Couldn't even say it's a give and go. Just pitch and catch between Herman and Devin Dodson. Bales had to pick somebody to try and save. He picked the wrong one. And Herman feeds Devin Dodson for the goal. And that is Devin Dodson's 13th of the season. And Herman will get the assist with around 7 minutes to go in the third period. So a 7-0 lead for the Capitals on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard. It is Jaron Beck. Nice couple moves around the defenders, but then eventually be taken by the Huron All-Stars. Herman gets pinned to the corner boards. With 6:20 remaining here in the third period. And as the All-Stars again, that will pick it back up, trying to set the breakout up, but the Capitals have none of that, and Jace Anderson is able to hold the zone for a moment, and it will eventually come out of the zone. And then a huge check, Jace Anderson with a big check as he was able to hit number nine in Michael Larson. This puck will come all the way down on net. Youngworth will leave it for Corbin Bystrom. 5:50 to go here in the third period. Bystrom's able to skate around at Ryder Casper. Then the pass goes back over for Jace Anderson. Trying to feed one a long way for Devin Dotson. That's intercepted. Moved back in by the All-Stars. There's a shot blocker down by Youngworth, and the rebound would have been probably handled a little bit differently, but knowing that that shot came so far away, that Youngworth was just blocker it down, and the Capitals move it back in as Keller Hermann. Nice stick there by the All-Stars to send it all the way down. They will ice it with 5:15 to go here in the third period. So a 7-0 lead on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard. With 5 minutes to go here in the third. Cruise right along in this third period. And again, we'll have the Pizza Ranch postgame show coming up after we're done here tonight, as Barrett Schweitzer will be in the corner. Trying to play it out, but it will be grabbed here by the Capitals. Now it's Alex McIntyre. Pass goes across. It'll come over to Bridger Babcock. That one came from Corbin Bystrom, but it will be out of the zone. And then Bystrom, who Bush was standing there waiting for an opportunity for a breakaway, but Bystrom was able to block the pass. Now he'll leave it for a centering pass. Dylan Dotson took an inadvertent knee and got tripped up, but play continues. Dylan Dotson will grab it again in the corner. Centering pass over, looking for an opportunity to try and get in the net with Schweitzer, and then it'll be sent all the way down. Youngworth has to play it as it went on net. And with 4 minutes to go here in the third period, it is Bridger Babcock that will play it up ahead for Schweitzer again. He's got 3 goals on the night so far. Pass across, trying to center one, maybe back for Schweitzer, trying to tip one. That one came from Dylan Dotson, trying to get it from Alex McIntyre. Now McIntyre in the corner, battling for the puck. Had two different Huron All-Stars around him with 3:40 to go in the third period. So the Capitals will win their fifth straight and seventh straight game, as there's a shot by Bush and a nice glove save by Youngworth. As that one, Bush tried to shoot that one with the screen of the defender, and Youngworth saw it all the way through and was able to make a glove save. So it'll be the fifth win in a row, seventh straight game with a point for the Capitals, as they go to 6-0-1 in their last 7 games. And the 2 games remaining this weekend are the big test for the Capitals. Asher Vandenbos moving it in, 3-on-2 in the zone. Vandenbos lost the handle of it and will come out of the zone as the pass goes across for Mason Hunter, but an offside is whistled against the All-Stars with 2:50 remaining. Capitals out shooting the All-Stars 7-2 in this third period. And for Jackson Youngworth, he is looking to get his third win of the season. In the next 2.5 minutes, it'll be his third straight goose egg as well. His one start with a loss, it was against the Watertown Lakers back early in the season. But he had a shutout win against Brandon Valley at the Denny Sanford Premier Center, and a shutout win against Sioux Center last time the Capitals played, which was 2 Sundays ago. As Keegan Kitts will dump it in the zone with 2:05 to go. And then here he will get his first home win of the season, go to 1-1 at home, 2-0 on the road. And Spencer Anderson, we are nearly sure that Spencer Anderson will get the start tomorrow against the Brookings Rangers. There's a penalty that's going to come up against the Capitals. A roughing call against Cameron Lee with 1:41 to go here in the third period. The sixth power play for the Huron All-Stars, and the final shot for the All-Stars to get on the board. Hermanson Endodontics penalty kill. The clock starts. We're under 100 seconds to go here in the third period. Anderson will try and clear the zone. Unable to. So now it's Botts that will have it. Bott, a pass across for Bush, trying to center one backdoor feed for Peterson, but that one was missed. And it'll go all the way down the zone with 1:20 to go here in the third period. Capitals have killed off all five penalties against so far. Bush with a shot up high. Youngworth makes the save, but it hit his helmet, and it popped his helmet off. So we get a whistle, and that one did not feel good for Jackson Youngworth. And under a minute to go here, and Youngworth's got to readjust his mask, and that almost could take us to the end of this hockey game. But Youngworth has to make his 13th save, and it rung his bell a little bit, but he seems to be okay. They do stop the clock with 49.7 to go, and they can probably restart the clock as the faceoff is won by the All-Stars. Ethan Bush at the blue line nearly comes out of the zone. Now it's going to be picked back up by the Capitals. Beck can't clear the zone with 40 seconds to go. But around it comes for Bush. And that one's going to be intercepted. Alex McIntyre trying to get a breakaway, but he just couldn't quite get the skates going in front of Ethan Bush. So now the game's down the final 25 seconds. This will be played to the side of the net. Youngworth will play to the corner. 20 seconds to go here in the third period. There's a pass that goes behind the net. Botts comes up to the near side boards. 10 seconds remaining. Capitals will pin it to the boards. Aiden Beam, 5 seconds to go. Beam will hold on to that puck, and that will take us to the end of the hockey game. And Jackson Youngworth has his third shutout in as many starts. And the Capitals win it 7-0 on the American Family Insurance Brittany Schuffelbein scoreboard. 7-0 win for the Caps here tonight. We'll step aside, come back with the Pizza Ranch postgame show after this. You're listening to Hawaii Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock. Watching it on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
Pizza Ranch of Fort Pier is a proud supporter of the Owyhee Capitals hockey. Bring your crew to the ranch. We have hot buffet options, including legendary pizza, the country's best chicken, savory sides, nutritious salads, and delicious desserts. Perched right on the river, our Fort Pier Pizza Ranch is only minutes away from the South Dakota State Capitol Building and from the Expo Center, home of the Owyhee Capitals. The Pizza Ranch in Fort Pier.
Ferdig Electric has a long history of doing electrical work the right way. Economical service, professional work, and customer satisfaction is why they can say that. Ferdig Electric can do residential, farm, and commercial projects. Doesn't matter if they are charged with new construction or a remodel project, they get it conducted. Contact the staff at Ferdig Electric at 224-8684. They can light a spark into your next project. Ferdig Electric, 224-8684.
Hello. I'm Pastor Jeff Lathrop of Pier First United Methodist Church, and I'd like to invite you to join us in person for worship on Sunday mornings at 8:30 a.m. or 11 a.m. You can also join us on Facebook Live or on KCCR 1240 a.m. or 98.9 FM for our Sunday morning broadcast at 11 a.m. Come worship with us at First United Methodist Church, where you will find open hearts, open minds, and open doors.
Smart, rugged, capable. The Ford F-150 pickup at Capital City Ford. The Ford F-150 offers impressive power you need with the efficiency you want. It's loaded with intelligent technology. You can load up, tow, and work from about anywhere. Capital City Ford carries the newest model offering hand-free highway driving, towing tech, and heads-up display. Now, qualified buyers can purchase a new 2023 Ford F-150 for 1.9% APR for 72 months. Check out their full vehicle lineup at CapitalCityFord.com. Capital City Ford in Pier.
The Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center in Pier is a proud supporter of Hawaii Capitals hockey. Ram Kota is more than just a place to stay. It's a full-service hotel where you'll arrive as a guest and leave as a friend. Enjoy our comfortable accommodations while you're in Pier. A full bar and restaurant, too. Best of luck to the Hawaii Capitals hockey teams. The support comes from your friends at the Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center. Ram Kota Hotel and Conference Center, 920 West 2 Avenue in Pier. Give us a call at 605-224-6877.
Dano's Marine supports Owyhee Capitals hockey. Stop in and see the new owners, originally from Pier, Brandon and Amanda Larson. Dano's Marine technicians are here to help with all your motor needs. They can rig accessories and electronics in all brands of boats or get you into a new boat or pontoon. Dano's Marine, 916 Deadwood Street in Fort Pier. Don't forget to winterize your boats. Call Dano's Marine at 605-224-6612.
South Dakotans, due to the recent flood, hail, and windstorms, many of you have damage and are in need of making repairs. When it comes to making the decision of who to hire to complete the repairs, you should always check with the Department of Revenue to ensure they're licensed to do business in South Dakota. And you should check with Consumer Protection to see if any complaints have been filed against the company. And finally, never sign anything until you read all the details. Rule of thumb, when someone knocks on your door to sell you a product or service, they need to provide you with a 3-day right to cancel. Go to consumersd.gov and look under Transient Vendors or call 800-300.
AGE Corporation has been building South Dakota for nearly 60 years. For all your site work, construction, and crane needs, AGE is there for you. If you need a boat dock and dock lighting, AGE has what you need. Visit their website, agecorp.com, or give them a call at 223-2732. AGE Corporation, providing high-quality services without sacrificing safety. Visit agecorp.com or call 223-2732.
Hi, this is Jaron Beck, captain of the Oahe Capitals, and you're listening to Oahe Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and watching on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports.
As we welcome you back here at the Pizza Ranch postgame show, we were joined here by Coach Steve Steele. And Coach, a 7-0 win against the Huron All-Stars. Did what you guys wanted to do, get 2 points, and did a lot of good things here tonight as well.
Yeah, you know, I think the guys did exactly what we hoped they would do. They got out early. We had good special teams for the entirety of the game. We're pretty solid defensively there, and, you know, we were able to get a lot of guys that are going to be playing a lot of minutes tomorrow and Sunday some rest.
Well, 100% on the special teams, 2-for-2 in the power play, 6-for-6 in the penalty kill. Now, I know you talked about in the first period, you don't want to be in the penalty box that many times, but got to be confidence in a late game situation if you have to be in the penalty box. Again, you don't want to be there, but when you are on there, the confidence the penalty killers have right now.
Yeah, you know, I thought both units looked really, really well today. You know, I think they both did a great job. Our entry was noticeably better today, you know, than it has been. You know, I think we finished, obviously, at both of them, but our entry looked a lot better, a lot more clean. And, you know, I think we actually we moved a little bit too much in our penalty kill, but, you know, we were able to get the job done. And, you know, again, a lot of confidence heading into tomorrow.
13 saves for Jackson Youngworth, his third shutout now and fourth shutout as a team for the Hawaii Capitals. We talked about the goalies being more confident as the season has gone on. There's not many teams that can say they got four shutouts in a season, regardless of the level of competition, who they're playing. It's easy for at least one goal to squeak in, but these goalies have now gotten four, and Jackson has got three in his last three starts. The nothing but confidence can come from this.
Yeah, no, I mean, and you know, again, some of these times they're hard, you know. I mean, there's teams where, you know, they don't score a lot of goals and they end up getting one just because, you know, again, there can be all kinds of bad things that just fluke bounces or, you know, we almost saw that in the first period there, that one that kind of went up over his head and he was able to get, I think, the tip of his stick on it to kind of knock it back where, again, that's not a shot on net. That's a dump in that, you know, hits somebody and careens up in the air and goes in the general direction of the net. And, you know, so it was a good job just, again, being aware for those types of moments and those freak accident type things that can happen. And, you know, when there was pressure, he was confident, he was steady. And when there wasn't, he was locked in and focused.
Going now to tomorrow, this is the two big games of the season to this point. Brookings and Rushmore, they're sitting atop the standings. Rushmore won 7-0 tonight. Brookings won 7-3. Over Sioux Falls West. Obviously, Brookings is your first priority because you're playing Rushmore on Sunday. What do you expect from the Brookings Rangers going into tomorrow night?
Yeah, Brookings is an extremely disciplined team. You know, I mean, they do what they do extremely well. They're very tough to crack defensively. They're very good in the neutral zone, and they just try and wear you out on offense. So, and you know, we cannot be in the penalty box as much tomorrow as we were today. They've got a really good power play that gets a lot of practice.
But, you know, especially here tonight, obviously being 10:40 right now as we're about to get, you know, wrap things up. Going to be a short night. Thankfully, you're playing at 7:15 tomorrow night and not, you know, at 11 o'clock in the morning. But how important is a rest tonight? And you know, it's cold outside, but doesn't mean that, you know, you got to be – rest is very important going into tomorrow morning and into tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah, rest and hydration is going to be key. You know, especially when it's cold, you know, you tend not to – feel the need to drink quite as much, you know, and to stay as hydrated with water and Gatorade. And, you know, so that's going to be a huge point for these guys to make sure that they're pounding the waters so that they can still, you know, their legs got to have two really tough games in them yet. So they've got to be able to stay in that.
Well, real quick, too, Barrett Schweitzer gets a hat trick. Dylan Dodson was a one goal away from a hat trick. Devin Dodson and Jaron Beck all score. Those two guys, especially in Barrett Schweitzer and Dylan Dodson, had two really good offensive nights, and everybody played well. And it was good to see, again, you accomplished what you wanted to do and hopefully created good habits outside of being the penalty box.
Yeah, I mean, you know, our white line's really doing a great job. You know, Barrett Dozark and Barrett Dozy and then Dylan. Those are the three guys. I mean, they're really clicking right now. They're playing really, really well. And, you know, they're, like I said, they're just grinders. You know, they're really hard. They're horrible to play against. And they're just they're a group of guys that just keep working, and that offensive ability is coming through.
Well, Coach, appreciate the time. Congratulations on the win, and looking forward to talking in the pregame show tomorrow evening.
Thanks, John.
That's head coach Steve Steele, the Hawaii Capitals. They win it 7-0 tonight over the Huron All-Stars as the Caps get the shutout from Jackson Youngworth, his third in his last three starts, and now will be winners of five straights and also points in seven straight games. They're 6-0-1 in their last seven games, so the Capitals are looking to continue that, but will have, of the points that they have been able to get and the wins that they've been able to get, this will be the toughest of those all tomorrow and Sunday when they host the Brookings Rangers tomorrow night and the Rushmore Thunder on Sunday. So we are going to be wrapping things up here. I want to mention, too, Barrett Schweitzer scored the first goal, made it in 44 seconds in. Dylan Dodson and Barrett Schweitzer scored 52 seconds apart to make it a 3-0 game. Then those two again scored 19 seconds apart and a minute and 5 seconds in combined over the second period to make it 5-0. Jaron Beck made it 6-0 on the power play. And Devin Dodson scored the lone third period goal to make it 7-0. And the Capitals get the win over the Huron All-Stars with Jackson Youngworth making 13 saves in net for the shutout for the Hawaii Capitals, who go 2-for-2 on the power play and 6-for-6 on the penalty kill. So tomorrow afternoon, we start coverage around 1 o'clock and puck drop at 1:30 between the Hawaii Capitals and Mitchell Marlins in the girls' varsity. Then the boys' varsity will have the Hawaii Capitals and the Brookings Rangers at 7:15 with puck drop and around 6:45 for pregame here on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports. I want to say thanks to Drew McIntyre back at the station. John Weichler here signing off. The Hawaii Capitals win at 7-0 over the Huron All-Stars as we say goodnight from the Expo Center.
Capitals Hockey on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports, presented by Capital City Ford, Lincoln, and Toyota. Oahu Capitals Hockey is brought to you by Hermanson Endodontics, AGE, Weatherall, Ramcota, Wagner Auto, Xander Auto Parts, Envirotech, Leisure Palace, The Clubhouse Hotel and Suites, the South Dakota Office of the Attorney General, Division of Consumer Protection, Pizza Ranch, Dano's Marine, American Family Insurance, Brittany Scheffelbein Agency, Ferding Electric, First United Methodist Church, and Beck Motors. Join us all season for Oahu Capital Hockey on Capital City Rock and on YouTube at Capital City Rock Sports. This has been a special presentation of Riverfront Broadcasting Sports, Central South Dakota's sports leader.